The judge in the case noting one of the suspects had not attended a single day of class this year.
Fox's Mike Emanuel in D.C. A superintendent's report last fall said 60% of D.C. high school students were chronically absent last school year. America is listening to Fox News.
93 WIPC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
You'll want to be prepared. Cloudy and 63 degrees in downtown Indianapolis. Nothing on radar around the Circle City, but rain expected later. Low of 58 tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 302. Severe weather could affect your evening commute, says Greg Mello with the National Weather Service.
Not only for Monday, but also into Tuesday as well. And, you know, the threat for severe weather will be impactful to anyone traveling, but also the threat for flooding, too. So you have to make sure that you're weather aware before you head out.
Mello says the exact timeline for when the storms could hit would be any time after 4 this afternoon. A man shot and killed by police officers in Indianapolis yesterday. Kurt Darling reports.
Police were first called at around 11 to an area near 33rd and Georgetown for an incident. They got there and a man drove off. That's when the cops chased him, and when he stopped.
Video shows the suspect standing in front of the house, holding the gun to his own head.
IMPD Chief Chris Bailey, that's when SWAT was called in. Later, the man tried to get away again, firing several shots at the officers who returned fire, killing him. Kirk Darling, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
The state of Indiana needs some improving, says former Indiana Attorney General Curtis Hill.
You absolutely market Indiana, but you have to have confidence and faith in that you have a marketable Indiana that can be attractive. We need to create the environment that our schools are wonderful, that our streets are safe, that our communities are thriving.
Hill is one of several Republican candidates for governor. You can hear his full interview with Tony Katz and his other interviews with other candidates on the WIBC.com. Congresswoman Victoria Spartz says the southern border needs to be addressed by Republicans either now or after the election.
The terrorists right now that can come through our border, and also the huge problem for welfare system. You know, we cannot have illegal immigration to welfare. Our system is already bankrupt.
She tells All Indiana Politics the reason she's seeking another term is because Republicans have failed to deliver on key issues like border security. She says she wants to help get it right. And former Colts cornerback Vontae Davis passed away today. Police say he was found unresponsive in a home. No foul play is suspected. He was 35 years old. You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 3:04.
You love spring in Indy, but you hate to paint. So do what Judy did. She called Rhino Shield.
The house that Rhino Shield did for my husband and I, after having the house painted with kind of usual house paint, I was seeing cracks appearing about every 3 years and just wasn't very satisfied with that.
Rhino Shield's a ceramic coating specifically formulated for our unique climate.
I can't speak highly enough about the Rhino Shield crew. They also were great at working with me to get the exact right color because I was very particular.
Indy, you too can have the guaranteed protection of Rhino Shield right now for 15% off the regular price.
I would not hesitate to call Rhino Shield, and I am just thrilled to recommend Rhino Shield to my friends and neighbors and family.
Here's Rhino Shield Shane Smith.
This offer is limited, so call me at 888-RHINO-41. That's 888-RHINO-41.
Don't paint.
Don't vinyl.
Go Rhino!
Paint your house again. Rhino Shield!
With traffic on the 5s at 3:05, here's Matt Bear.
All right, Harrison, looking at northbound 37, stop-and-go traffic, Epler up to 465 because of road construction. Outside of that, 465 looks pretty good around the construction zones. When that starts to change, I'll let you know. Traffic sponsored by the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. Guys, solve your ED today with an intimacy guarantee only at the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. If you don't perform, you don't pay. Call the Indianapolis Men's Clinic at 999-9000. That's 999-9000. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
For today, scattered strong storms possible in the evening hours, widespread showers and storms in the overnight, high temperatures in the mid-60s. Tonight, low temperatures in the mid-50s. I'm WishTV StormTrack 8 meteorologist Ryan Morse for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the level on the go and on WIBC.com.
Hammer and Nigel.
You believe these characters are weirdos?
So let's rock it!
Hey, now. It is the Hammer and Nigel show. Good to be back. Missed you guys. I'm Jason Hammer. Big Nige is out. It's his week to be on spring break. And coming out of the bullpen once again, my man, Jerry Lopez, Indy Spanglish on social media. How are you?
Doing great. Always nice to get in here and let you guys put your toes in the sand for a little bit.
So I'm enjoying a beautiful weekend, you know, white sands down at Sandestin, Florida, Redneck Riviera right there on the Gulf, trying to escape everything going on, just decompress a little bit, right? And then late Saturday night, early Sunday, my phone starts blowing up again. You know, texts, you know, messages, social media posts. Another mass shooting downtown Indianapolis. Another high-profile tourist area that is a centerpiece of violence, Jerry. We're not talking about back alleys of 38th Street. We're not even talking about late night on the canal. Over the last couple of years, we've seen a big shootout near the hotels and bars on Meridian Street. If you remember, one of the Dutch soldiers was murdered. We've seen a shooting in Broad Ripple that fatally killed someone. And now, this past weekend, another mass shooting as a bunch of juveniles out late, downtown, no adult supervision to be found anywhere, shot over by Circle Center Mall, over by the Steak and Shake.
Yeah, and the youngest is 12. Think about that. I have a 12-year-old daughter. I can't even imagine her being out at that time of night, let alone in that kind of situation.
All of the victims are in stable condition. That's good news. The IMPD earlier today say they have taken two people into custody. That's even better news. But man, again, high-profile tourist areas. This is a city that puts on a lot of events, right? Even when we're not hosting Final Fours or tournament games or, you know, things like that. Businesses come to Indianapolis because it's an amazing place to have a convention. The city's connected. We do things well. We roll out the red carpet. The folks visit Indy, maybe the best in the country at doing what they do, driving tourism. Because let's be honest, Indianapolis is not Miami.
Right.
It's not South Beach. We've got Beach Grove. They've got South Beach. But yet we still drive tons of visitors for conventions here. And that's because the amazing work of the folks that work in that industry. But it's becoming harder and harder for those people when you've got this type of nonsense happening on the regular.
Yeah, and when you look at it, well, we had the All-Star Game, we had the Combine, we had the first round of the March Madness tournament. Like you said, we had the FAA coming to town, we have the NRA. Funny enough, the NRA is the safest weekend that the city will see for the whole year.
Right.
Because everybody has weapons and they know not to bring that here. But with all these other cities starting to build up, you know, whether it's Milwaukee or Cincinnati or Indianapolis has got to do a better job of curbing the violence downtown if we want to keep a lot of these events.
So after the mass shooting that took place outside of the mall across from the Steak and Shake, there was a press conference that the IMPD hosted.
When there's a bold disrespect for law enforcement authority and the laws of our society, it's a problem that's bigger than the police.
It's a problem that's bigger than the police. Because for so long, and Jerry, you know this, we keep hearing about, well, we need police reform. We have to find the root causes. Usually those two statements go hand in hand, right? I'm past that. I'm somebody that lives here. I live in Marion County. My parents live here. My family lives here. We're lifers. I'm done with the let's just try to find the root causes thing because I think we know what the root causes are. You've got a lot of hot spots in this city where there's not a parent to be found.
Oh, definitely. And let's make parenting great again, right? Like, let's go back 10, 15 years where they really started to put the handcuffs on parents and say, you can't discipline your kid. You can't do this. You can't do that. And I think we're starting to reap what we've sowed with what we've done there. This is the participation award generation. This is the generation of your opinion matters, and I have to take into consideration your feelings, and therefore you start to misconstrue authority, right? If you don't respect your parents, if you don't respect teachers, what makes you think you're going to respect strangers?
And why do you think all of these people that come to downtown feel like they can do whatever they want? Why is that a feeling that anybody that's coming downtown to go to one of the nightclubs, to go out to one of the restaurants, whatever it is, They feel like they can be above the law. How did we get that way? And maybe people like us are the only ones ticked off because we're a city that keeps electing Joe Hogsett and Ryan Mears by 60% margins. It's not like either one of these cats just barely escaped last time. Now, the opponent for Joe Hogsett shot himself in the foot, no pun intended, by going against the Second Amendment. But man, Ryan Mears had a good challenger in Cindy Carrasco, and still 60%. People are just brainwashed in this city to go vote blue.
Yeah, we just keep doing the same thing, electing the same people and expecting different results, right? Definition of insanity is see also Indianapolis.
Right. Here now to share his thoughts on what's happening in the city is AI Joe Hogsett.
Well, you dummies voted for this. You keep voting for Ryan Mears and I, and then wonder why thugs feel welcome in Indianapolis. What the hell did you expect? Now, if you will excuse me, it's time for another sing-along.
Interesting choice.
Tequila.
I don't know why, Jerry, but every time AI Joe Hogsett does a sing-along, it's a song about alcohol.
My AI's getting pretty good these days. Almost unidentifiable.
The reason you know that wasn't the real Joe Hogsett, there wasn't a slur there right? It was too clear. $975 million. That is the current Powerball jackpot. Jerry Lopez, Indy Spanglish, you hit this jackpot tonight. Will we have you on this show tomorrow filling in, or are you donezo? Will we never see you again?
Oh, you're going to have me, but it'll be the last time you'll welcome me back on this show. Because I'm going to air out everything. 975. I don't even play. I have too much teeth to win, right? Like, if you have all your teeth,
don't even play.
Don't even play. You have to have three teeth and be like 80 years old.
I may or may not be a bandwagon lottery guy. Right? You know how some fans jump on the bandwagon when a team is successful?
Oh, when it gets hot, you go.
Right. Like, I'm sure there's a lot of new Purdue fans. You know, oh, I've always been a Boiler fan. When the lottery gets this high, I'll jump in. I'm bandwagon lottery guy. Now, I'm a gambling degenerate. I make no bones about it. And I say that as a term of endearment because I'm on a heater in terms of March Madness. But I don't normally do the lottery all that often. But if you're telling me I can put a couple bucks down for a chance at almost $1 billion, I think I'd be doing myself a disservice if I didn't play, Jerry.
Are you coming to work tomorrow?
Oh, yes. And if you thought that I was arrogant or a pain in the backside before, get ready, Bal, because you haven't seen anything yet.
Wait till Jason doesn't need the check.
Right, right. We talked about this before, and a listener made a great point. Someone tweeted in and said, if I won the lottery, it would be like in those Marvel movies where you see the lab accident that creates the villain. That would be me if I won $975 million. I would take the cash payout. That's only, air quotes, $471.7 million. So again, I'll turn to you. Would you be a one lump payment guy, or do you want it spaced out throughout the rest of your life like that Bobby Bonilla, you know, Otani contract?
No, I want it all up front. I want to make sure that, you know, the kids are set up. I want everything set up so I don't have to worry about it.
Because I don't know what the rules are. If you kick it tomorrow, like if you get hit by a car or Joe Hogsett, Ryan Mears at Indianapolis, you get brutally murdered walking across the street, like that payment stops.
I think it goes back to the state.
So, yeah, get that lump sum. And before we hit a traffic break with Matt Bear here, I think what we need to get us in the mood to build some luck up for tonight, how about great moments and local TV reporters asking people about the lottery history?
Hammer and Nigel present great moments and local TV reporters asking people about the lottery history.
I'm here with someone else who has gotten their ticket. Now, James, you bought your ticket. What are you going to do with that money if you win?
Well, I'm definitely going to get a new supercharged Mustang with dual exhaust and about 5 kilos of cocaine, and I'll be good to go.
Okay, so you like cars. You like cars.
Great moments and local TV reporters asking people about the lottery history.
And the reporter was spot on. She didn't even miss a beat. Oh, so you like cars. Just going to ignore that whole cocaine part that aired on television.
Matt Bear, you win the lottery. You showing up to work tomorrow?
No, I'm not showing up anyway. But I'm just gonna take random days off in the middle of the week. Northbound 37, stop and go traffic, Epler Avenue up to 465 because of construction. And southbound 65 slows into the north split from West Street. Traffic sponsored by the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. Guys, solve your ED today with an intimacy guarantee only at the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. If you don't perform, you don't pay. Call the Indianapolis Men's Clinic at 999-9000. That's 999-9000. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates. Sad WIBC traffic.
So some parts of the WIBC listening area might see a little action in terms of weather, mainly in the southern portion of our listening audience. Here in central Indy, don't think it's going to be too bad, but you could see some storms a little bit later on, wind, maybe a little hail. We'll let you know if anything gets a little dicey. Right now, though, 62 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center. Don't go anywhere. We're going to have a lot of fun today. You'll laugh, you'll cry, you'll wet yourself. It's the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Get 3 rooms of carpet cleaning starting at $139 plus $75 off air duct cleaning too. Call 317-388-5141 online at zeroresindy.com.
According to a 2023 Gallup poll, 71% of non-retired adults are worried about retirement saving. At Howard Bailey Financial, we don't believe retiring with confidence should be guesswork. In fact, our mission is to help you gain clarity and purpose and elevate meaning in your life through personal and practical financial strategies. That's why we provide our Retire with Purpose Toolkit at no cost. In it, you'll find valuable information on minimizing taxes, maximizing Social Security, and building a retirement income you won't outlive. To receive your complimentary toolkit, text CLARITY to 866-482-9559. Take a step toward a more confident retirement with Howard Bailey Financial and text CLARITY to 866-482-9559.
This endorsement was not provided by a client of Howard Bailey. This individual was compensated for this endorsement. For more information, visit howardbailey.com/TS1.
Business. It's all the things that keep this world turning. And behind every one of these companies is a partner helping to keep it all moving. It's why the local flower shop and your favorite pizza joint, the startup in the stadium, hospitals and hotels, banks and restaurants nationwide, all choose the Advanced Network, Cybersecurity Solutions, and round-the-clock trusted partnership from Comcast Business, the company that powers more businesses than anyone else. Comcast Business, powering possibilities.
See why Comcast Business powers more small businesses than anyone else. Get started with fast speeds and advanced security for $49 a month for 12 months with a 2-year contract when you add one unlimited mobile line. Plus, ask how to get up to an $800 prepaid card with a qualifying gig bundle. Don't wait. Call to switch today. Ends 5/6/24. Restrictions apply. New customers only with 100 megabits per second internet and security edge. Ecobill and autopay required. Equipment, taxes, and fees extra.
Did you know that the tubs and showers installed by most bathroom remodelers aren't waterproof? I'm not kidding. They're not waterproof. That's because the other guys cheap out and put acrylic caulk directly on acrylic tub and shower panels. You can't do that. Water will seep through, and then you've got mold, mildew, and rot. To do it right, you have to first prime the surfaces, then apply the caulk, then you have to seal the caulk. It's a 3-step process. Prime, apply, seal. If you've ever seen shower seams with mold growing on them, well, now you know why. Some cheapskate decided to save $25 in materials and 20 minutes of labor. And now you have a mold and mildew problem. Call Baths R Us instead. We never cut corners. We always take our time to do it right for a 100% waterproof installation every single time. Call now and get $1,500 off plus low to no monthly payments. Our number is 317-886-1761 or online at BathsRUs.com. That's BathsRUs.com.
Fellas, there's a lot of people talking about testosterone, but do your homework and go to a provider that you can trust. We recommend Low T Center to get your levels checked. At Low T Center, they make it quick and easy. You walk in and take a simple blood test, and you'll get your results back in about 25 minutes.
If you've been feeling tired, grumpy, have noticed weight gain and loss of muscle mass, you may have low T levels. Go to LowTCenter.com and book your appointment online. That's LowTCenter.com. Low T Center, reinventing men's healthcare.
Sometimes I struggle to get to sleep. My body stopped for the day, but my mind is still running. So I take ZQuil.
ZzzQuil, the world's number one sleep aid brand, has a range of non-habit-forming products to fit you and your family's needs. Invest in a great night's sleep for the best you tomorrow.
I'm awake and ready to take on anything.
Better days start with ZzzQuil Nights. Explore our products at ZzzQuil.com.
Use as directed. Keep out of reach of children.
You're listening to the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Yeah, you always got to pay respects to the people that came first. He built this. None of us, that doesn't go over any of our heads. Like he helped set all this up, so he was kind of paying back, giving a little piece of that is the least I can do.
That was Purdue star Zach Edey talking to the media about why he gave a piece of the net that they cut down to former Purdue coach Gene Cady. It's the Hammer and Nigel Show. And yes, I can stand here and take the heat. I feel like the Joker, you know, like Jack Nicholson's Joker, just standing there in the street with his hands in the air saying, come on, my Tennessee Volunteers got beat by the Purdue Boilermakers yesterday. And Purdue, for the first time since 1980, punched their ticket to the Final Four, Jerry.
Yeah, a rough week for Hoosier fans. You have the Purdue Boilermakers in the Final Four. You have Indiana State in the NIT Final Four. And the Hoosiers are just at home. Or as Charles Barkley would say, they've gone fishing.
They've gone fishing. I told Rob and Casey earlier when I went on their show, somebody needs to make Mike Woodson just sit in a chair and they need to hold his eyes open like mafia guys used to do for torture. Make him watch the Purdue Final Four game and see all of the gym rat Indiana kids that are out there. Because I saw this breakdown of all the players in the Final Four. 20% are from the state of Indiana. Now, obviously, the bulk are playing for Purdue, but not just Purdue. But keep in mind, Mike Woodson, he looks at some of these Purdue kids. It's like, no, I don't want to recruit them. Why would you want that slow kid right there? And it's a formula that's been true since Butler made their back-to-back title game appearances. You get your star, your McDonald's All-American. He can be from anywhere. And then you surround him with gym rat Indiana kids. You're going to win some basketball games. Not everybody has to be a five-star, take off from the free throw line, you know, amazing athlete. You need smart basketball players, guys that are willing to accept their role, and shooting. Sweet mother of God, you need some shooting, and you can win some basketball games. So again, I hope they make Mike Woodson get strapped into a chair and force him to watch what's happening on the screens this weekend.
Yeah, I was a huge fan of Mike Woodson when he got hired. And, you know, you have experience in the league, experience in college, and you come to IU, which I still consider a blue-chip school, and you have underperformed year after year after year. And the thing that I really like about Purdue is they know who butters their bread. Okay, when they come down the court, they may swing it around a couple times, but Zach's getting the ball.
Yes.
They double down. They'll kick it back out to Braden Smith. Zach's getting the ball again.
And those kids know their role.
Yeah.
They're fine with that. They don't have like six or seven dudes that are like, what about me?
Nope.
And teams win games. And Purdue's a great team right now. Now, they've also got a 7'4" dominant big man, so that goes a long way as well. But here's the thing Purdue fans need to understand. This Saturday, America's big man is not wearing gold and black. He's wearing red and white. The big fella from NC State, the fat guy from NC State, that's who's playing against Purdue. That game starts a little bit after 6 o'clock on Saturday. Unless you're a diehard Purdue fan, you're an alum, or you're from Indiana or West Lafayette, America's rooting for the underdog. That's how the tournament works. And NC State, they're the underdog. They're the 11 seed. They had to win the ACC tournament just to get in, and they're led by a big, fat, ball-playing machine. This kid is amazing, and he's athletic. He can lead the break. He's got spin moves, and they list his weight, Jerry, as 275. And if that kid from NC State is 275, then I'm 7'4", and I'm going to be the first pick in the draft. That kid ain't seen 275 since middle school. That's a big dude, but he's awesome. He's got skills, and he's fun to watch, and it sounds like he's a pretty good guy, too.
Yeah, he's 23 years old. They got him listed at 6'9", 275. I saw a tweet today that said NFL GMs are starting to be really interested. And it wouldn't be the first one, right? Tony Gonzalez. A lot of these big guys will turn into tight ends or something like that, but that's a big boy.
Like, I don't even think he's going to be tight end. You're talking about guard.
Right. It's a big right? boy.
He went from playing college basketball to being a lineman, which is amazing. We got some other action going on. You've got tonight the women's game, LSU against Iowa. Now, there's some bad blood here. If you only watch one women's basketball game all year, watch this one tonight because there's going to be trash talk. You've got a high-profile coach that's, you know, just had a Washington Post hit piece against her. Last year, if you remember, in the title game, Angel Reese against Caitlin Clark, you know, a lot of trash. I'm here for that kind of stuff. Pacers in action tonight. And this Friday, I bought tickets earlier today. If you're a baseball fan, get your tickets for the Indianapolis Indians game this Friday because on the mound will be Paul Skeens. He was the number one pick in the baseball draft last year. Folks on social media might know him as Mr. Livy Dune, the LSU gymnast. It's her boyfriend. They're like the power couple from LSU. But he throws around 100 miles an hour. He's been just filthy. He's not going to be in Indy very long. He's going to be in the show pretty soon. And your chance to say, hey, I saw a Major League Baseball all-star here in Victory Field could be this Friday when he takes the bump for his first home start. Again, I don't know how many home starts he's going to have here, but he's been filthy, and I'm looking forward to that. All right, do not go anywhere. More Hammer and Nigel show coming up.
Jefferson Shreve stepped up to fight when no one else would. He put it all on the line, and the liberals smeared him for it with ads like this.
Donald Trump and Jefferson Shreve. He's an original supporter of Donald Trump.
They attacked Shreve for being a conservative.
Jefferson Shreve, an A rating from the NRA.
Attacked him for being a loyal Republican.
Look who was there, Jefferson Shreve. He was proud to be on the Trump campaign and proud of his own A rating from the NRA.
All because Shreve would get tough, back the blue, and stop the crime. But we don't have to accept their lawlessness at our border, in our suburbs, in our state. Because Jefferson Shreve is running for Congress, and he's a fighter for law, order, and a secure border. Jefferson Shreve for Congress.
I'm Jefferson Shreve, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Shreve for Congress.
Attention seniors, you're invited to the grand opening of CenterWell Pendleton Pike. CenterWell offers primary care centered on seniors. So come celebrate on Wednesday, April 10th at 8101 Pendleton Pike, Suite E in Indianapolis from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Enjoy food, music, and more at this free community event. Plus, tour the new doctor's office and meet the care team. For details, call 317-648-5581 or visit meetcenterwellindiana.com.
Sometimes I struggle to get to sleep. My body stopped for the day, but my mind is still running. So I take ZzzQuil.
ZzzQuil, the world's number one sleep aid brand, has a range of non-habit forming products to fit you and your family's needs. Invest in a great night's sleep for the best you tomorrow.
I'm awake and ready to take on anything.
Better days start with ZzzQuil Nights. Explore our products at ZzzQuil.com.
Use as directed. Keep out of reach of children.
93 WIBC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
Severe storms on the way. 66 degrees, cloudy downtown, no rain on your radar, but that's expected to change sometime today. Low temps to the upper 50s tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 3:30. Rain, hail, strikes of lightning, and more possible this evening.
I would say the isolated tornadoes are possible today. And then tomorrow, while there is a lower threat at this time tomorrow, looks like if the latest model trends are true, then we could have a higher tornado threat tomorrow than we're currently expecting.
Greg Mello with the National Weather Service. The threat for severe weather Tuesday is expected to drop off in the evening. For the rest of today, though, keep an eye on the radar. Republican candidate for Indiana Governor Curtis Hill says his campaign isn't focused on other candidates.
We're not out there slinging unnecessary mud. We're talking about the issues that people are interested in. We're talking about assault on absolute truth. We're talking about the manipulation of justice, the weaponization of race, the sexualization of children.
Indiana's former attorney general is one of several candidates who spoke with Tony Katz. You can listen to those interviews at WIBC.com. Congress is still looking for a compromise on foreign aid and funding for the southern border. White House Press Secretary Karine Jean-Pierre says the ball is in Republicans' court.
He wants congressional Republicans to pass, to move forward with a bipartisan border security agreement. A bipartisan border security agreement that was supported by the Border Patrol Union, U.S. Chamber of Commerce, something that we don't see nowadays.
That bipartisan deal was a result of talks in the Senate, but Republicans now say the package doesn't do enough to keep migrants from crossing the border illegally. And a Grammy Award-winning blues rock duo will be in Indy this fall. Sam Fritz reports.
The Black Keys announced on Monday that they're going to be rocking Indianapolis in 2024 as they will stop by Gainbridge Fieldhouse on October 26th as a part of their International Players Tour. The tour is in support of their similarly named upcoming album, Ohio Players, which will feature collaborations with other big artists like Beck and Noel Gallagher of Oasis. Tickets go on sale the same day the album releases, April 5th at 10 a.m. They can be bought at LiveNation.com or TheBlackKeys.com. Sam Fritz, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 3:32.
April is here, and with the springtime weather, it's important to have quality windows. If yours won't open to let the fresh air in, won't seal tight to keep out the pollen and the bugs, or have been leaking water all winter, then it's time you talk to the experts at Window Nation. Right now, for every two windows you buy, you'll get two windows free. There's no limit on how much you could save. Plus, you could save even more with no interest or payments for 24 months. Window Nation's windows come with a lifetime warranty and can be installed in one day or less. Call 866-90-NATION or visit windownation.com.
Don't miss out on your chance to afford quality windows with this unlimited buy two, get two free, plus zero interest or payments for 24 months. You cannot afford to wait. 866-90-NATION. Or visit windownation.com, schedule your free in-home estimate. Window Nation, tell them Hammer and Nigel sent you.
With traffic at 3:33, here's Matt Baer.
All right, Harrison, south side crash westbound 465 after Harding Street. Right lane is blocked and traffic is slow back to Harding Street. And a crash, this on the southeast side. It's Brookville Road west of Shadeland Avenue. Two vehicles involved. Somebody was trapped inside. They're able to get themselves out. It's still a crash with injury. Again, this is Brookville Road west of Shadeland Avenue. Please be careful in that area. Traffic sponsored by Sullivan Hardware and Garden. This week at Sullivan Hardware and Garden, get 30% off all patio furniture, wicker, Berlin Gardens, polycast, aluminum, teak, and more. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
For today, scattered strong storms possible in the evening hours, widespread showers and storms in the overnight, high temperatures in the mid-60s. Tonight, low temperatures in the mid-50s. I'm Wish TV Storm Track 8 meteorologist Ryan Morse. For 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Zilcox on The Level on the Go and on WIBC.com.
The only way to bag a classy lady is to give her two tickets to the gun show.
It's Gun Day with the Gun Guy.
Just watch out for the guns. They'll get you.
Guy Wilford.
Stop calling your arms guns.
The Hammer and Nigel Show.
He is a 2A instructor, the host of the Gun Guy Show, and a damn fine American. Guy Relford, how are you?
I'm great, and thanks as always to our sponsor for Monday Gun Day. That's Premier Arms in Brownsburg, with the largest selection of new, used, and historic firearms in the Midwest. And PA Jewelers, located right in the store. Check them out at 3754 South Green Street in Brownsburg, or premierarms.com.
You sent me a link to a story that Channel 13 did.
Yeah.
Which I'm always hesitant to watch Channel 13 because right. Those guys are hacks.
Right.
Like, I just can't stand those guys.
Have you gotten your apology from them yet, by the way?
Oh, I'm still waiting. And it's okay. Not just 13. There are other little butt sniffers in the city that were real quick to judge when I said there were shenanigans taking place at Camp Atterbury.
Right.
And then all of a sudden the government writes a big check for all the damages caused. And I'm still waiting for my apology from a number of people, but including Channel 13.
And by the way, just so you know, and I've told you this before, whenever I've gotten an interview request from Channel 13, I've said, have you sent your apology to Jason Hammer yet? And the reporter never knows what the hell I'm talking about. But when they dig it around a little bit, they come back and go, well, no, not yet. I'm like, then I'm not talking to you.
Well, I appreciate
that. Look at that.
Thank you for that. But you sent me this story that they did where I watched it a couple times because I wanted to make sure that I wasn't just judging them because I don't like them. It made it sound like we should be scared of people defending themselves in their own home.
Yeah.
That's the story, okay? So I'm going to play you a couple different sound bites here, then I want your reaction.
You bet.
Because maybe it's just me here. So Channel 13, WTHR, they ran this story about a lot of these self-defense shootings that are taking place here in Indianapolis.
January 3rd, a man allegedly wrestled a gun away from an intruder in his home, then shot and killed the man. January 5th, a woman shot and killed her boyfriend, who was allegedly attacking her. Several more shootings and a violent start to 2024, where the circumstances and culpability were even less clear. Someone died, but no one was ever charged with a crime.
Okay, so that's one piece of this story, and it's about a 2 or 3 minute piece, and then, this is the money shot, they get to Prosecutor Ryan Mears. This is what he had to say about law-abiding citizens or people just defending themselves.
What's upsetting to me is if you look at the month of January, I think we had 18 homicides during that month. 14 of those were being investigated for self-defense, meaning that someone lost their life and that case might ultimately be cleared. But that doesn't do anything for that family who lost someone.
Man, who cares? Who cares? If that's my daughter, I hope she shoots her abusive boyfriend and he dies.
And if you're at home minding your own business and somebody breaks into your house looking to do harm to your daughters or you, kill the bastard. I'm sorry.
This dude feels sorry for the family of the criminal?
That's our take, Guy. Where are you at?
Well, it's upsetting to Ryan Mears that potentially 14 out of the first 18 homicides this year in Marion County were self-defense, legal, justified. Self-defense. And listen, they're being investigated. Maybe there are more facts to come out. And I fully acknowledge that. But how shocking is that? That's upsetting. Because what you have here is you've got 14 bad guys that are not going to be bad guys anymore. You've got 14 victims of violent crimes who are going to survive and get to go home to their families every day. And that's upsetting to Ryan Mears. I do not understand it. Well, I do understand it to the extent I understand the politics of Ryan Mears. But you know what I think? And I put this out on social media. You can see it at Guy Relford on Twitter or my personal Facebook or Gun Guy WIBC. But I put out there and I said, you know what this story really should have been captioned? It should have been captioned as or titled as the media, IMPD, and Ryan Mears are upset that law-abiding citizens being armed and capable of defending themselves, right, is concerning to them. It's disappointing that law-abiding citizens can defend themselves in Marion County and Indiana generally.
And I don't think it's the IMPD rank-and-file officers.
No, hell no. Right. No, I would never say that.
They would probably encourage it. The rank and file officers would go, you know what, you're going to call us. We hope you can defend yourself till we arrive.
I totally agree. It's not rank and file. In fact, I got a big thumbs up on this from someone we both know who represents a lot of IMPD officers. But I will speak for them. But no, it's a leadership, right? And
right.
And they were quoted, right? New Chief Bailey was quoted in this same story going, yeah, we're really worried about all these self-defense shootings. You know what? Constitutional carry works. Law-abiding citizens being armed and capable of defending themselves against crime works. That's what you're seeing in Marion County, and the Democrats, the liberals, and the people who would rather victims die, so then they have more of an argument for gun control, they're actually upset about it. It was bizarre to me. I absolutely could not believe the article when I went through and listened to the whole thing.
What are the chances that people are arming themselves and being more prepared because of the rise in crime in Indianapolis?
Oh, 100%. no doubt. I mean, that's the best point yet. I mean, that is really the point. When people see those murder numbers, and people see even during the Summer of Love, right, where the authorities completely gave up and turned the city over to a bunch of criminals and thugs, a whole bunch of people turned around and said, no, I'm going to have the capacity to defend myself, defend my home, defend my family. And I know, because those people come to me for training very, very often. And that's exactly what they tell me. I don't want to be defenseless in my home because there's not anybody else out there to help me. And the bottom line is that's true. But for Ryan Mears and the media to come out and say that's a bad thing, that people are successfully defending themselves, is just mind-blowing to me.
Allison, we're going to have to play Ryan Mears one more time because I just can't believe this is the prosecutor of a major city that's had a crime problem, record crime in the last 5 years. And even though we haven't reached record level since, it's been above 200 homicides. Sure, right. That's the new norm. And your prosecutor that got 60% of the vote in this county wants us to feel bad for the family of the person that tried to beat someone's daughter or break in and kill someone.
What's upsetting to me is, if you look at the month of January, I think we had 18 homicides during that month. 14 of those were being investigated for self-defense, meaning that someone lost their life, and that case might ultimately be cleared. But that doesn't do anything for that family who lost someone.
Unbelievable. That's real. That's not AI. That's not something that I did on my computer. No. That is your prosecutor, Marion County.
Well, and listen, anybody who knows me or listens to my show or hears me on Monday Gunday on Hammer and Nigel knows that I don't celebrate the loss of any human life, right? There are people out there, including you, Jason,
I do.
Who are more
it when bad guys die, guy.
Right. I mean, you're more mercenary about it than I am. But listen, I get it, and I don't want people to lose their lives. But at the end of the day, there's no way you can avoid the fact that as between the good guy and the bad guy losing their life, who would we prefer? We would rather have the bad guy lose their life. And there's no way you escape from that under the law of Indiana and under any sense of justice. And for our prosecutor here in Marion County to come out with a different view, again, it's just completely mind-boggling.
I would like to see of those 14 self-defense cases, how many of those perpetrators that were shot were reoffending criminals?
Great question. Fabulous question.
How many of those have been let go time and time again by Ryan Mears with very little consequences until they F around and find out?
Absolutely. Right. And you know, when Abdul puts his numbers out at the end of every year, or, you know, right after the end of the year, where he has numbers like, you know, 80-some percent of suspects in homicides in Marion County have passed violent felonies on their record, exactly to your point, Jerry. And even many of the victims do as well, because they're out there, they're in beefs, they're shooting each other. I get it. But to that point, to say that, you know, a guy defending his home or a woman who's defending herself against an abusive boyfriend, that's the problem and that's what they're concerned about, my God, what a misplaced sense of priorities that might be.
The whole report from Channel 13, again, just my perspective. You can watch it on their website for yourself and find out how you feel.
And I've posted the links.
But it feels like they're upset that, well, we're not quite sure we can prosecute somebody now. Like, they're more upset that there's a bad guy that's not going to be around anymore than a victim that may have got shot, but at least they know who to prosecute.
Yeah.
Well, if the left can let dead people vote, we can prosecute them.
There you go. Monday Gunday with Guy Relford here. I'm going to play another piece of audio for you here. This was a pretty powerful moment from a parent of a victim of the Parkland High School shooting.
Oh, yeah.
That was down in Florida. Marjorie Stoneman Douglas or something like
Marjorie
that.
Yeah, Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida. That's exactly right.
So the father of the 14-year-old victim was not real happy that Kamala Harris came down to Parkland and basically did a photo op calling for gun bans as opposed to trying to come up with real solutions to make kids safer in school. Take a listen to this. This is Ryan Petty. Again, his student was killed during the Parkland shooting, 14 years old. This is what he had to say about Kamala's visit.
What they want to do is create an opportunity for the vice president to spout gun control talking points at a site that quite frankly, is hallowed ground at this point. And so I find the whole thing offensive. Nothing is going to change with this administration. They're not interested in understanding all of the work that was previously done and things that we've done in the state of Florida to protect our schools. They're just there, quite frankly, for a photo op, and I'm tired of it.
Yeah, this is powerful stuff. Again, as you mentioned, Jason, this is Ryan Petty, who lost his 14-year-old daughter, Elena, in the Parkland High School shooting. And not only is he the father of a victim, but he also participated in the Parkland School Shooting Commission, where they heard hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of hours about what exactly happened to allow that shooting to occur. And you know his conclusion? We don't need more laws. We don't need more gun control. We don't need to ban weapons. What we need to do is to follow up when law enforcement officials have reports of violent individuals who are threatening mass shootings, even specifically threatening school shootings. Then law enforcement needs to do their job and follow up. We need school resource officers who, unlike the coward in Parkland who hid behind his car in the parking lot while he listened to kids in the high school getting murdered. Rather than that, we need schools that are secure. This kid walked across campus with a rifle bag. Multiple people saw him. Nobody called a code red. Nobody called a lockdown. He walked through an unlocked door and was able to walk from classroom to classroom to classroom and murder students because those classrooms locked from the outside in. The people in those classrooms, students and teachers, could not lock the doors. He went through all those details and was able to spell out for regulators and for law enforcement, what do we need to do to keep kids safe? We need to keep bad guys out of our school. We need to keep bad guys away from our schools. And we need law enforcement, including school resource officers, to do their job. Those are the conclusions from the Parkland shooting. And he's offended, and rightfully so, that Kamala Harris came down there and used it as a photo op for more gun laws.
Can you come back for one more quick segment?
Always.
Monday Gun Day with Guy Relford. It's the Hammer and Nigel Show.
It's the first day of the first grade, and she found a new best friend. It's a laid-back Sunday afternoon you wish would never end.
The homemade taste of Bluebell and good friends gathered round. The good old days are being made right now.
St. Louis brought the world gooey butter cake. Now Bluebell brings us gooey butter cake ice cream. A cake batter ice cream with a luscious cream cheese swirl and gooey butter cake pieces. Mmm, it's the gateway to the best in pints and half gallons.
The good old days are being made right now.
The good old days are being made right now.
Look for Bluebell ice cream at Walmart Supercenters and Walmart Neighborhood Markets.
Congresswoman Spartz will be ready for your interview soon.
It seems pretty intense in there.
Yeah, kind of crazy. Maybe I'll take some time before the interview to Google Victoria Spartz and learn a little more about her. Whoa. Have you seen this article?
One aide calling the lawmakers' workplace behavior manic?
Victoria Spartz was number one on Legistorm's list of worst bosses based on high turnover rates.
Says she, quote, avoided firing aides and instead bullied them until they left.
And the story is based on interviews with half a dozen former staffers.
Yikes. Spartz called staff morons and idiots.
Get this. Victoria Spartz says her working style is, quote, not for everyone.
Well, it's not for me. I think I'll pass on this interview.
I'm Chuck Goodrich. I'm running for Congress, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Go With Chuck Goodrich Committee.
Hammer and Nigel here for our friend Mark Deedle, markdeedle.com. Mortgage rates have lowered going into the spring selling season, and now is the time to act to maximize your equity. Mark Deedle, he's got the plan and the experience to sell your home fast and for maximum value this spring. Listen, let's be honest. You have a lot of options in the real estate game. Everybody seems like they're a realtor now, but you work too hard for your money to trust your friend or your buddy. Go with the best. And
The National Weather Service in Indianapolis has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for northern Monroe County, south central Morgan County, southeastern Owen County, until 4:15 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. At 3:37 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, a severe thunderstorm was located near Spencer, or 9 miles northwest of Bloomington, moving east at 35 miles per hour. Expected hazards include 60 miles per hour wind gusts and quarter-size hail. This is a radar-indicated threat. The following impacts are expected. Hail damage to vehicles is expected. Expect wind damage to roofs, siding, and trees. Locations impacted include Bloomington, Hillettsville, Lake Lemon, and Unionville. Remain alert for a possible tornado. Tornadoes can develop quickly from severe thunderstorms. If you spot a tornado, go at once into the basement or small central room in a sturdy structure. For your protection, move to an interior room on the lowest floor of a building. Repeating, a severe thunderstorm warning has been issued until 4:15 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time for the following counties in Indiana, Monroe, Morgan, and Owen.
By our friends at Thompson Furniture and Mattress in Columbus.
This week at Sullivan Hardware and Garden, see their large selection of grills, Weber, Traeger, and Napoleon, along with the Big Green Egg.
Keeping our eye on some weather, we'll update you right after Matt Baer checks the roads.
South side crash westbound 465 after Harding, blocking the right lane, causing a slowdown of about a half a mile. Southeast side serious crash, Brookville Road west of Shadeland Avenue. Two vehicles involved, somebody got hurt. Traffic sponsored by Sullivan Hardware and Garden. This week at Sullivan Hardware and Garden, see their large selection of grills, Weber, Traeger, and Napoleon, along with the Big Green Egg. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
We've got a severe thunderstorm warning for northern Monroe County, south central Morgan County, and southeastern Owen County until 4:15 p.m. We're talking about quarter-sized hail, wind gusts around 60 miles per hour. Spots like Bloomington, Ellettsville, Lake Lemon, Unionville, you are included. So be weather aware. Here in Indy, right now, it's 61 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center at 93 WIBC. Guy Relford with us Monday Gun Day. And Guy, the Supreme Court is considering whether or not to take on a couple different two-way cases here. What's the ramifications of what they're talking about?
This is a big one. And if they take these cases, and depending, of course, on what the outcome is, this could affect millions and millions of people. Right here in the U.S., and that is, it's a Vincent case and the Range case, and the issue is, should nonviolent felons, and in the two cases, one lady at 19 wrote a bad check to a grocery store, and another guy on his application for food stamps lied about his income. They both got convicted of felonies. They both are prohibited under federal law from carrying a firearm because they have a felony conviction. And the real question before the court, if they take the case, is whether nonviolent felons, just because the crime they were convicted of carries a sentence of potentially over a year, they should be deprived of their Second Amendment rights. And it's a big deal, and it influences an awful lot of people, potentially, depending on what they do with it. And you know, it comes back to this new test we have before the Supreme Court, which is does the history and tradition of regulation of the Second Amendment support the idea that nonviolent people should be deprived of their Second Amendment rights? I think this court, if they take the cases, or either one of them, could very easily come back and say, no, it's only violent people that should be dispossessed of their firearms.
Got about 30 seconds left. Is this something that is a state's rights issue, or is this something at a national level?
Well, it's a federal statute that we're talking about. So federal law, and now if depending on how they come out, it could definitely influence a lot of state laws as well, and then it could turn into a 10th Amendment issue, as you mentioned. But really, the bottom line is, no matter what the level of regulation is, should these people be deprived of their Second Amendment rights when they're not violent? An awful lot of us say, oh, hell no.
Where can we find you, hire you, stalk you, and love you, Guy?
RelfordLaw.com is the best place to get a hold of me. RelfordLaw.com.
Guy, you're the best. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Again, keeping our eye on the weather, we've got a severe thunderstorm warning for northern Monroe County, south central Morgan, and southeastern Owen County until 4:15 p.m. B-Town, Bloomington, this is you. Ellettsville, Lake Lemon, Unionville, this is you. We will keep you up to date on everything going on with the weather and have the top stories of the day coming up next. Don't go anywhere. It's the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Did you know that April is Foot Health Awareness Month? Hi, this is Phoebe, and at the Good Feet Store, we think every month you should be aware of your foot health. Your feet support everything you do. Why wouldn't you want to properly support your feet in return? Foot health starts with having great support in your shoes, and with a selection of over 300 different styles and sizes of arch supports, we can help you get back to wearing your nice dress shoes, stylish flats, or even sandals in comfort. Listen to Ava's real Good Feet story.
I love shoes. You find them in the store. You know, they like call you, but they hurt. The best ones hurt the worst. And you're walking around going, I don't want anyone to know that I'm not happy. Stuck in the arch supports, and I felt so much better. I'd say Good Feet help with all of my great shoes. They turned out to be something that actually works for me. My name is Ava, and that's my Good Feet story.
Don't overlook your feet. Make sure they get the care and attention they need so they can keep supporting you. Find the Good Feet store nearest you at goodfeet.com. We look forward to helping you find better foot health.
Attention Indiana homeowners, are you dealing with a wet and moldy crawl space? Hi, I'm Adam Swain with Swain Co. Crawl Space and Basement Repair, your real, local, Indiana family-owned experts dedicated to fixing your crawl space right the first time. And with our new no-interest, no-payment financing, you can get the repairs you need without breaking the bank. Don't let crawl space water problems dampen your spirits. Call Swain Co., Indy's most trusted waterproofing experts at 317-407-1868 or swainco.llc.com.
Life insurance. Why are you putting it off? Can't afford it? Too much hassle? Think you don't need it? There's lots of excuses for putting off life insurance. But if you weren't there, who would pay the mortgage and other bills? With Ethos, you could be covered in 10 minutes and boom, family protected. Ethos, fast and easy online term life insurance. Up to $2 million in coverage with no medical exam. Some policies as low as a dollar a day. Answer a few health questions and get your free quote at getethos.com. That's getethos.com.
That moment when you realize you have a serious air conditioner issue. A real strip down to your skivvies, no one sleeping tonight, head in the freezer fail party. But fear not, there's an expert for that.
Let your local experts at Broad Ripple Service Experts keep you cool. Get worry-free comfort for one low monthly payment.
Wanna chill? There's an expert for that.
Call Broad Ripple Service Experts at 866-EXPERTS. See website for license details.
Attention seniors, you're invited to the grand opening of CenterWell Pendleton Pike. CenterWell offers primary care centered on seniors. So come celebrate on Wednesday, April 10th at 8101 Pendleton Pike, Suite E in Indianapolis from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Enjoy food, music, and more at this free community event. Plus, tour the new doctor's office and meet the care team. For details, call 317-648-5581 or visit meetcenterwellindiana.com.
Coming up in 2 minutes, what you need to know about the chances for severe weather this week. A severe thunderstorm warning in Morgan County. That lasts until just after 4. How one candidate for Indiana governor wants to improve the state. And a former Colts quarterback was found dead in his home this morning. All that and more coming up after Fox News Radio from the Technology Recycler Studios. You're listening to 93 WIBC, WIBC HD1 Indianapolis. It's 4 o'clock.
Progress in Baltimore. I'm Lisa Brady, Fox News. Maryland Governor Wes Moore just announcing that a temporary channel has been opened on the northeast side of the collapsed Key Bridge.
They cut up and lifted a piece of the north section of the Key Bridge. The entire operation took 10 hours. And in that time, they were able to cut and lift a 200-ton span of the bridge.
Multiple cranes and tugboats are part of the salvage operation aimed at reopening the port of Baltimore as quickly as possible after a cargo ship hit the bridge last week. This as the investigation continues, along with the recovery of four construction workers' bodies still missing. President Biden plans to visit Baltimore on Friday to see the damage firsthand and meet with state and local officials. Iran's elite Revolutionary Guard now says seven of its members, including two generals, were killed in an airstrike in Syria Syria's capital, Damascus, where Iran's consulate was hit. State media reports in Iran and Syria blame Israel, which has not commented.
The strike took place in a building just next to the Iranian embassy in the capital of Syria. This has raised questions about the IRGC activities in Syria and questions about what the response will be from Iran. There have already been a number of threats thrown out today by the regime in Tehran, with Iran's ambassador to Syria saying the response will be swift, direct, and harsh.
Fox's Trey Yingst in Tel Aviv. One of the generals killed was believed to be facilitating weapons shipments to Iran proxy groups in the region. Just getting word that the last living survivor of the USS Arizona has died. Luke Conter was 102. He was a quartermaster standing on the main deck of that battleship when Japanese planes attacked Pearl Harbor in 1941. A mixed finish on Wall Street. The Dow down 240 points at the bell. America is listening to Fox News.
93 WIBC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
It never hurts to be prepared. Cloudy, 67 degrees in downtown Indianapolis. Radar shows storms over Morgan County near Martinsville. Severe thunderstorm warning there until the 4:23 this afternoon. Low temps tonight drop just below 60. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 4:02. Severe thunderstorms expected today with the National Weather Service not ruling out the threat of a tornado.
Besides the severe weather, we also have the potential for flooding as well, so we need to be watching for that.
Greg Mello with the National Weather Service says there could be more storms tomorrow. Rain right now hitting Martinsville with more storms to the south. Attracting top talents to Indiana through marketing is harder than it sounds. Ryan Hedrick reports.
And that's where Curtis Hill, former Indiana Attorney General, says he can impact the state as your next governor.
We need to create the environment that our schools are wonderful, that our streets are safe, that our communities are thriving.
And he says you could do that by supporting small businesses, backing the blue, and investing in students and not systems. You could see the full interview with Curtis Hill and Tony Katz at WIBC.com. Ryan Hedrick, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
Former Colts cornerback Vontae Davis has died. He was found unresponsive in his home at the age of 35. Police say for now they do not believe foul play was a factor. There was a small private plane crash west of Delaware County Regional Airport in Muncie this morning. Three people were hurt. Two of those three had been walking in the Cardinal Greenway Trail when the crash happened. The other person hurt was the pilot of the plane. All three are in the hospital. Indiana Congresswoman Victoria Spartz says a big issue that seems to be getting swept under the rug this election cycle is getting Hoosiers better access to health care.
And it's really access to health care is getting worse and worse for many Americans. And health care is really, it's a health and productivity, but it's really an issue that can change people's lives.
She tells All Indiana Politics that health care is also a good chunk of the national debt, which makes it a national security issue. And the average price you're paying for a gallon of gas today is $3.40 in Indiana. That's according to GasBuddy.com. It's 10 cents cheaper than the national average. You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 4:04.
You love spring in Indy, so don't spend it painting. Do what your neighbor Mike did. He called Rhino Shield.
Our home is basically a contemporary, and we just started noticing that the paint was just fading and just looked like garbage. We had received a postcard from Rhino Shield, and we decided to take a look at it.
Rhino Shield's formulated for our specific climate here in Indiana.
The process with Rhino Shield and their crew, they were just very conscientious. We had problems in the past with painters. They leave debris and everything. Well, we didn't have that with Rhino Shield.
Way better than paint, backed by a 25-year warranty. Right now, get the guaranteed protection of Rhino Shield for 15% off the regular price.
The thing about Rhino Shield, the heat gain has been reduced, and we save $70 a month. You don't hear that about any type of paint.
Here's Rhino Shield's Shane Smith.
This offer is limited, so call me at 888-RHINO-41. That's 888-RHINO-41.
Don't paint.
Don't vinyl.
Go Rhino!
Paint your house again. Rhino Shield!
With traffic on the fives at 4:05, what's going on, Matt Bear?
Harrison, eastbound 465, a little bit slow. Keystone Avenue over to Allisonville Road. Southbound 65, stop and go 21st to Meridian 10. And a slowdown coming into downtown from the west side on eastbound 70 after tips to Belmont. Traffic sponsored by Freegee and Freegee Auctioneers. Join Freegee Auctioneers for the Spring Midwest Construction and Farm Public Auction on Thursday, April 4th in Clayton. Bid live on site or online at buyfreegee.com. Licensee
563-1200002. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
For today, scattered strong storms possible in the evening hours, widespread showers and storms in the overnight, high temperatures in the mid-60s. Tonight, low temperatures in the mid-50s. I'm Wish TV StormTrack 8 meteorologist Ryan Morse for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the level on the go and on WIBC.com.
Hammer and Nigel.
Can you believe these characters are weirdos?
So let's rock!
Keeping our eye on the weather. Severe thunderstorm warning. Monroe, Morgan, and Owen counties. A couple more minutes until 4:15 p.m. Wind, hail, cats and dogs living with each other. That's what we're talking about here. We'll keep you up to date. I'm Jason Hammer, Jerry Lopez, filling in for Big Nige. So how did you spend yesterday, Jerry? I'm not talking about Easter. I'm talking about the trans day of visibility.
I did what I thought I was supposed to do. I walked around downtown and just pointed at all the trans people and said, I see you, and then just went to the next one.
Because that's what Joe Biden wanted to have happen when he put out this statement over the weekend in kind of the weekend news dump style after hours when he thinks the media would be a little softer, that what used to be Easter Sunday, one of, if not the most important holiday,
probably the most important holiday to Christians,
would also be the trans day of visibility. Yep. So I'm confused on the messaging here. And again, I'm not even trying to be a smartass. We were talking about this in the back.
Yeah.
For years, members of the gay community, the bi community, all they wanted was to be treated like everybody else. Yep. That's it. Don't point me out.
That's equal rights.
Right. Yeah. Don't point me out. Just want to be able to get married to who we love. These types of things. But then the trans folks came along, and it seems like they're a little bit more, hey, you better pay attention to us, but if you point it out, you're some sort of ist or a phobe. Like, I don't understand the messaging here. What's the point of this?
I'm confused how 2% of the population got so much power. Right? Like, minorities have been fighting for equal rights. Took them 40, 50, 60, 100 years. And we have 2% of the population that can rewrite science. We're not going to say question. Rewrite science. And in my America, you can do whatever you want. If you're trans, I support your right to be trans. I don't have to agree with you. And I think that's the part that we lose track of, right? Like, you can be trans. I can put on a skirt, but that doesn't mean I can go in the women's restroom and make everybody else uncomfortable.
And it doesn't make you a bad person if you don't care about someone's sexuality.
Dude, I have four daughters. I'm not going to let Jason Hammer in a skirt go in the girls' restroom.
Right, right.
It's my job to protect them.
And if you see someone trying to do that, it doesn't make you the villain for being concerned about that. And that's kind of where we've become here. It went from, hey, everybody just wants to love everybody, equal rights, that's what we're about. Don't point me out, I won't point you out, to now, you've got a whole hot mess of stuff going on to where if there's not a national holiday that coincides with Easter, and if you don't celebrate it, you're part of the problem.
So is today a trans day of invisibility again? Like, how does that work?
Does it go back? I don't know. I really
don't
know.
It's like the LBGT superheroes.
And I'm wondering, and if you fall into one of these categories, please let us know, at Hammer and Nigel. I'm wondering how other members feel about the trans community. And I'm talking about the L, the G, the B, right? How do they feel about the trans folks kind of hijacking what used to be, hey, we've got Pride Month, we're happy, it's easier to be gay now than it used to be. Fine, good for you. Want to get married? Knock yourself out. Hey, pay some taxes, let's go. But now you've got the trans community and it's almost become their front and center. Everybody else takes a back seat. And I'm wondering how the gay community, the bi community, how they feel about that.
So I've come to terms with the fringe sides are the loudest, okay? Whether it's the far ultra right or the far ultra left, those sides are the loudest. And I think this is just another one of those examples where You know, I think I asked you pre-show, like, do the T's mess it up for everybody else? Because I feel right. like conservatives, liberals, people in general don't have a problem with L, B, or G at all.
None.
Do you? If you want to get married, you have a right to get divorced like everybody else. Right.
If you want to be miserable like the rest of us, go ahead.
There it is.
There's the joke. Are you happy, people?
Yeah, but like... For this, we're questioning science. We're not questioning your right to do something. You have a right to do whatever you want in America. I fought for you to have that right. That's who needs rights. The one-off. The person that wants to kneel for the flag. The person that wants to identify as female. But with that right comes the other side where we don't have to support you.
I just always found it weird. And whether it's gay or straight, celebrating someone's sexuality. Like, I'm not a Valentine's Day guy, and Allison knows this. I hate Valentine's Day. I think it's a stupid Hallmark holiday designed to make you buy flowers and cards and crap when you should love whoever you're with every single day. Holidays designed where you're supposed to celebrate your sexuality have always been weird to me. I don't think that's something you celebrate, who you choose to have sex with, whether it's a man, woman, dog, hole in the wall, I do not care. I don't want a parade. I don't want to see it on television. And again, that's just not me. I'm not a strip club guy either.
I'm not either.
So,
but I was in the Army. So
I think when you're younger, like you go for the experience, you know, bachelor parties, you end up there. Yeah. But, you know, some dudes like our age now, Jerry.
That's sad.
They're sitting up there on Pervert Road. It's the highlight of their week.
I'm good.
Yesterday... This was wild. Pro-Palestinian protesters took over the Easter Vigil Mass at the St. Patrick's Cathedral in New York City. Keep in mind, the St. Patrick's Cathedral, one of the crown jewels of organized religion in this country, and the Easter Mass, the most important day, you had pro-Palestinian protesters going up there, interrupting the service, chanting Free Palestine. Now, ultimately, they were taken away by some members of the church, but, I mean, how would you feel if you went there just to pray to your God, to be around people that you like, your congregation, and you got the pro-Palestinian protesters up there? What do they expect the people in that crowd to do?
Whoever's running this marketing campaign needs to be fired.
Right.
Like,
what do they want them to do?
You want me to support Palestine? Hand out free sandwiches around the circle and have conversations with me. Don't disrupt traffic. Don't disrupt the airport. Don't come in here in Easter Vigil. Have a conversation with people.
My favorite was when they protest outside the NBA All-Star game. What do you hope happens when you do that? Do you want Carl Anthony Towns to get on the phone and call Netanyahu? Is that what you're looking for? Do you want Steph Curry to come out and maybe make a phone call? The people going to that game coming out wearing Halliburton, Giannis, and LeBron jerseys, what do you think they are going to do?
All you've done is made a conversation take place. Dad, what is that? Oh, don't pay. Now the kids are scared, and now I'm mad that you've made my night whatever you made it. Like, it's not, we talked about last week, so, you know, people cement themselves to the street. And just leave them there from here on out. Right. If you cement your protesting butt to West Washington, now you're going to take a left on West Washington and Hammer Road because he's in the middle of the lane.
Right. I just find it hard to believe that old Bibi Netanyahu is going to pick up the bat phone. Man, Joel Embiid was right. Maybe we need to stop this whole thing. Thank you, protesters at the NBA All-Star game. It worked. So ridiculous. By the way, the Easter egg... What's it called? The roll at the White House? The Easter roll this year. There were a couple strict rules. Number one, no crosses or nothing religious painted on the Easter eggs. All right, fine. But number two, listen how Joe Biden introduces the Easter, and I can't stress that enough, Easter bunnies.
And I'm coming down to do that Easter egg roll in just a minute. Thank you all so very, very much. Thanks, everybody. And by the way, say hello to Oyster Bunnies. Come on up, bunnies. Get up here so they can see you.
The Oyster Bunnies were out there, Jerry.
Goes great with oyster crackers.
The Oyster Bunnies. Wow. Matt Bear.
All right, south side, westbound 4.
465 delay has run out from Harding Street to the White River. We are all cleared out there now. Eastbound 465, a little slow in that Harding Street exit as you make your approach. Southbound 65, stop and go from 29th to Meridian Penn, and on the east side, northbound 465 slows at East 56th Street. Traffic sponsored by Freegee and Freegee Auctioneers. Join Freegee Auctioneers for the Spring Midwest Construction and Farm Public Auction on Thursday, April 4th in Clayton. Bid live, on site, or online at buyfreegee.com. License AC3120002. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And again, like Jerry and I were talking about, I think the big misconception about conservatives is that you guys don't like gay people. No, not at all. We just don't like being bullied into celebrating some sort of holiday when there's already one that exists. Like, don't, you know, listen to the mainstream national media. Those conservatives, they don't like gay people. That's the biggest load of crap in the world. It is. The modern conservative does not care. But when you start forcing us to watch you do your thing, then it becomes a little bit of an issue. And when you try to hijack Easter, that's where you've got a problem. I'm sorry. Keeping our eye on the weather, some spots have it better than others. Down south, still getting some storms. 64, the American Standard Heating Weather Center. Is this anything? Next.
Well-changing question. Are you keeping as much of your investment gains as possible? High taxes can erode returns quickly, so you need a tax-optimized portfolio. At Creative Planning, our money managers and specialists work together to make sure your portfolio and wealth are managed in a tax-efficient manner. It's what you keep that really matters. Why not give your wealth a second look? Book your free meeting today at creativeplanning.com. Creative Planning, a richer way to wealth.
Hammer and Nigel here for Window Nation. It's a critical time to check on the windows in the homestead because the weather this time of year is crazy. 1 minute it's 60, the next minute it snows. Some days you get severe storms, some days you get nothing. But if you have energy-efficient windows from Window Nation, you will not have to change a thing. Energy-efficient windows, they make sure that the perfect climate in your house stays right where it is, and the crazy weather outside stays out there. And you're also going to notice that your bill is lowered as well. I know this firsthand because I am a customer. And right now, you can be a customer with this deal at Window Nation. Buy two windows, get two for free. And if that's not enough, pay nothing with no interest for two full years. 866-90-NATION. Call Window Nation. They'll answer any question you have. 866-90-NATION or go to windownation.com.
Attention seniors, you're invited to the grand opening of CenterWell Pendleton Pike. CenterWell offers primary care centered on seniors. So come celebrate on Wednesday, April 10th at 8101 Pendleton Pike, Suite E in Indianapolis from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Enjoy food, music, and more at this free community event. Plus, tour the new doctor's office and meet the care team. For details, call 317-648-5581 or visit meetcenterwellindiana.com.
Michaelis presents Password. The word is basement.
Wet.
Rain.
Leaky.
Faucet.
Stinky.
Socks.
Moldy.
Underwear.
No, it's basement. Really moldy underwear.
Well, sometimes.
Ew.
Basement waterproofing and French drains. Life happens. Michaelis happens to help you through it.
Call today. Make it Michaelis. Michaelis.
Come on, take your basement back. 844-FIX-INDY.
Sometimes I struggle to get to sleep. My body stopped for the day, but my mind is still running. So I take ZzzQuil.
ZzzQuil, the world's number one sleep aid brand, has a range of non-habit-forming products to fit you and your family's needs. Invest in a great night's sleep for the best you tomorrow.
I'm awake and ready to take on anything.
Better days start with ZzzQuil Nights. Explore our products at ZzzQuil.com. Use as directed. Keep out of reach of children.
QC Kinetics announces the arrival of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Sheinkup, an acclaimed orthopedic surgeon with two decades of experience and extensive research in regenerative medicine.
But I was one of the first orthopedic surgeons to do it, and at the same time, I integrated clinical research that's resulted in several publications that are really directing the future of regenerative medicine. I was drawn to QC Kinetics after I reviewed their protocols, and everything they were doing is consistent with my own approach.
Today, Dr. Sheinkup leads the entire team of medical professionals at QC Kinetics, taking this exciting medical breakthrough to a whole new level.
What we are doing at QC Kinetics is transforming lives.
Get lasting joint pain relief. Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
This is the future of medicine.
Call QC Kinetics, 317-559-PAIN. That's 317-559-PAIN. In Eagle Creek, Greenwood, and Carmel, 317-559-PAIN.
Mow the distances back at your local Gravely dealer. Now through April 8th, you can save up to 25% with special financing available on America's most rugged mowers, including the ZTHD, the residential mower built to commercial standards. Visit your local Gravely dealer today.
Hammer and Nigel presents...
Is...
It depends upon what the meaning of the word is.
Is this anything?
All right, let's rock and roll. Rock and roll.
This is how we're going to do Is This Anything. I'm going to run some stories by Jerry Lopez, who's pinch hitting for Big Nige. He's going to be the one that breaks down all the information and tells you if the story is really anything or not. And we start with this. An Oregon man was nearly killed when a 4-foot-tall construction saw, the big blade of the saw, got loose and came hurtling towards him at a high rate of speed just as he was walking inside of a convenience store. It jammed in the door as soon as he closed it. A second earlier, it would have split him in half. Here is Shane talking about what happened.
I mean, obviously it wasn't my time, but it's probably the closest I've ever experienced it. So I was walking into the store here, put my handle on the door, and I heard a loud bang and yelling over here at the corner. Just as a cloud of smoke pops up, and I see a guy fall into the ditch and a 4-foot blade hurling at me as I'm walking through the doorway. I was thinking maybe it's my time, but I don't think I would have survived being touched by that thing.
Not anything?
That's crazy. Yeah, so I had this video up on my Twitter, at Indy Spanglish. That guy cheated death that day. I don't know if you get a chance, check out that video. As soon as he walks in the door, this blade is just flying across the street and sticks into the store door. He definitely would have died. I don't know if he needs to buy a lottery ticket or change his underwear. Maybe both. But yeah, that's his lucky day.
I'm looking at this video right now. Wow. I'm retweeting it from your account, Jerry, and this is a big blade.
Yeah.
I mean, that thing would have just went through him and sawed him in half.
100%. It looks like a blade that a magician would have used to cut a lady in half. Like, it's a big saw blade.
Unbelievable. I just retweeted it at Hammer and Nigel. Is this anything? A 9-year-old in California led the police on a short car chase because he was trying to drive himself to school. 9-year-old leading the police on a chase, but he was trying to go to school. Here's the officer talking about what happened.
Several other officers showed up as well, and it was kind of like one of those no one really believed it kind of thing. So several officers did show up to the scene just to see, in fact, that it was a 9-year-old driving the vehicle. A few seconds later, I did notice a little head bopping inside, made an approach, and as I was approaching, I could see a kid, which turned out to be a 9-year-old child, sticking his head out saying, "I'm sorry, I'm trying to get to school."
About anything?
I don't know how I feel about that. He was trying to go to school. Obviously, it sounds like he pulled over for the police.
He did everything right.
Yeah, I would like to know where the parents were that this kid felt like he had to take it upon himself to drive to school.
I mean, did they just fall asleep? Was this even a school day? Like, there are a lot of questions here. Like, you're right. On one hand, I commend the kid because 9-year-old Jason Hammer steals a car. We're going to Tijuana. This kid steals a car. He wants to go to school. And, you know, he's doing everything right. He's pulling over. But the problem is he's 9.
Yeah, luckily, nobody got hurt.
Right.
Especially him or anybody else walking. Or, yeah, that's scary.
Is this anything? A Florida woman had $3,000 worth of damage to her car when two dogs started going after her cat that was inside of her car. Here is Christine talking about two dogs and one cat.
I thought somebody had maybe taken a BB gun and shot my car. No one believed it was dogs until after they saw the video. And if they can do that to metal on a car, they tear a human being up. There's no doubt in my mind if they'd gotten that cat, she wouldn't be here today.
And Jerry, this isn't the first time we've had a story on this show about, you know, wild dogs. You know, Ricky Bobby warned us, packs of wild dogs that run most major cities tearing apart cars. We had a story about a car dealership, you know, dealing with this problem where these packs of wild dogs were just ripping their cars apart. Is this anything?
I mean, that's terrifying, actually. If you can rip apart metal and you're going after a car, right? You're going after a car. That has to attack any person walking down the street, right? Anybody, any kid on a bike, anything moving like that. Those are little mutants.
Right. Little Satan spawns.
Yeah.
Is this anything? An American Airlines passenger was arrested for public intox after berating and hitting airline staff and then mocking police officers about their salary, their height, and the size of their junk. She also happened to wet herself during this whole ordeal. Here is the moment that Angela Nicole Killian was finally arrested.
You're under arrest for PI.
Okay, now you're under arrest.
Yeah.
What did I do exactly?
You're under arrest for public intoxication.
What did I do? Stop! All right. Stop!
We're charging with resistance.
I have a recording! Pieces of mediocre your life. You make yourself feel good, making $60,000 a year. Yeah. You feel good your wife with your 5-inch.
Are you done yet?
Yeah. Stand up.
Okay, stand up.
That anything, Jerry?
And once you pee yourself, you lose the argument.
All the other things that you have said.
Once you wet yourself, you lose.
Go out the window when you pee yourself. It's the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Get ready for storm season because you know as well as I do, storms in Indiana can be fierce and they can come out of nowhere. So don't wait for a leak to have your roof inspected. Have peace of mind about your roof being able to handle any storm. Moss Roofing, M-O-S-S, mossroofing.com provides free inspections and can spot potential issues before they turn into costly repairs. Whether you're looking for a siding replacement after a strong wind or a roof replacement after a hailstorm, Moss Roofing has options that fit any budget. Just ask Moss Roofing about their payment plans. No matter your situation, Moss Roofing has you covered with a job done right every single time. I love that. That's very funny. Contact Moss Roofing today. 317-747-3665. 317-747-3665. Tell them Tony Katz sent you. Moss Roofing, 747-3665 or online at Moss, M-O-S-S, mossroofing.com.
I feel occasional burning and stabbing in my hands as I age.
I sometimes feel numbness and tingling in my feet as I get older.
It's starting to get in the way of doing what I love.
At Nervive, we hear you, and we can help. Nervive's clinically studied dose of alpha-lipoic acid reduces occasional nerve discomfort in as little as 7 days with continued daily use.
Now that I know, I'm taking control.
Try Nervive Nerve Relief and say yes to healthy nerves.
These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
Now is the perfect time for you to call the Bath Authority to get your project you've been putting off done this spring. Because the Bath Authority has an unbelievable deal going on. Call today at 317-532-5711. 317-532-5711. Schedule your free in-home estimate and get $1,000 off a new shower or bath, plus 36 months of interest-free financing. That's right. All you got to do is call today at 317-532-5711. Schedule a free in-home estimate with the Bath Authority and get $1,000 off a new shower or bath plus 36 months of interest-free financing. Walk-in tubs, replacement showers, tub-to-shower conversions, and more. The Bath Authority does it all. 317-532-5711 for $1,000 off a new shower or bath plus 36 months of interest-free financing. TheBathAuthority.com. Tell them Rob sent you.
93 WIBC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
Chances for severe weather, cloudy with temperatures in the mid-60s downtown. Radar shows some rain moving through southern Johnson County. Low temperatures tonight to about 58. I'm Harrison Silcox for Moss Roofing. Here's what's trending at 4:30. There's a threat for severe weather most of this afternoon.
A large hail, mainly that large hail threat. Across the northern portion of the area, we're expecting more just a large hail threat. Less of a tornado potential, wind gust potential tonight, this evening into tonight.
Greg Mellow with the National Weather Service says there's a possibility for a tornado as well. He expects the worst of any storms south of the I-70 corridor. Looks like some rain headed to Columbus on your radar. Indiana candidate for Governor Jamie Reitenauer wants to take a more local approach when it comes to state taxes.
That's why the approach that I'm taking with taxes to go to the ground level, to talk to the counties, to have conversation about, you know, sewer and water, the infrastructure we know in many of the counties, that's going to be a problem.
Reitenauer is one of several the candidates to speak with Tony Katz about her campaign. You can find all of his interviews at WIBC.com. Police say a man's in custody after ramming his car into a security gate at an FBI office in Georgia. There are no injuries. The suspect has not been ID'd. Anything about a motive has not been reported either. The damage to the front of the car, though, can be seen on security video. The White House is investigating reports of a top Iran military commander being targeted in an Israeli airstrike in Syria today. Reports say that strike took out part of the Iranian embassy in Damascus. And yet, a Congresswoman, Victoria Spartz, says a big issue that is getting swept under the rug this election cycle is getting you better access to health care.
And it's really access to health care is getting worse and worse for many Americans. And health care is really, it's a health and productivity, but it's really an issue that can change people's lives.
She tells All Indiana Politics that health care is also a good chunk of the national debt, which would make it a national security issue. A mixed day on the market. The Dow dropping 240 points to close at 39,566. The NASDAQ was up by 17, finishing at 16,396. The S&P 500, though, dropping by 10 points to finish at 5,243. You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 4:32.
It's the first day of the first grade, and she found a new best friend. It's a laid-back Sunday.
The homemade taste of bluebell and good friends gathered round. The good old days are being made right now.
St. Louis brought the world gooey butter cake. Now Bluebell brings us gooey butter cake ice cream. A cake batter ice cream with a luscious cream cheese swirl and gooey butter cake pieces. Mmm, it's the gateway to the best in pints and half gallons.
The good old days are being made right now.
The good old days are being made right now.
Look for Bluebell ice cream at select Kroger stores.
The traffic at 4:33. Here's Matt Baer.
All right, Harrison. Crash approaching downtown eastbound 70 before West Street. And the left lane is blocked, causing stop and go traffic back to Belmont. Southbound 65 coming into downtown. Stop and go traffic from 29th Street to Meridian Penn. East side northbound 465 slow. Roll off Penn Pike up to 75th. And westbound 865 stop and go traffic right now before Salem Road over to I-65. Traffic sponsored by Sullivan Hardware and Garden. This week at Sullivan Hardware and Garden, get 30% off all patio furniture, wicker, Berlin Gardens, polycast, aluminum, take it more. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
For today, scattered strong storms possible in the evening hours, widespread showers and storms in the overnight, high temperatures in the mid-60s. Tonight, low temperatures in the mid-50s. I'm Wish TV Storm Track 8 meteorologist Ryan Morse. For 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the level on the go and on WIBC.com.
The Hammer and Nigel Show.
It is the Hammer and Nigel Show. I'm Jason Hammer. Nigel celebrating spring break with his family. But we got Jerry Lopez here, Indy Spanglish on social media. And let's go to the hotline and bring on Dr. Curry Myers. Now, Dr. Myers is a criminologist, author, consultant. You had a pretty interesting Substack post the other day, and it's something that we've been talking about a lot on this show, Doctor, about how some of these politicians, local leaders, they're trying to do victory laps on crime numbers, but we could all see with our own eyes that it's a load of you know what. Take me through a little bit of what you wrote.
Well, thanks so much. It's a pleasure to be on your show. My Substack I wrote, which I write, try to write at least once a week, and I have a podcast as well. It's drcurrymyers.substack.com. And in this particular incident, I was watching the State of the Union address, in particular because I wanted to hear the president's criminal justice public policy, or lack thereof. And I was actually astonished when he made the statement in its quote, "Last year, the United States had one of the lowest rates of violent crime, all violent crimes in more than 50 years. Murder, rape, he repeated himself like he does. Aggravated assault, robbery, all dropped sharply, along with burglary, property crime, and theft." And I sat up on the edge of my seat, and I go, this is another example of, I used to think this is maybe misinterpreting things, but it seems to me that in particular, this administration likes to establish a new norm with any kind of numbers. And I think you could even cite financial numbers, economic numbers, immigration numbers, all these things. So to just point out criminal justice is just one example.
Here in Indianapolis, what we see is that we had a record number of homicides 2 or 3 years ago. And ever since then, it's gone down just a little bit, but still substantially higher than anything we've ever experienced in our lifetime, with the exception, you know, of the last couple of years. They're doing a victory lap on it now. They're making it sound like 200 homicides is the new norm, but at least we didn't set a record, so you're welcome, Indianapolis. That's the kind of thing that we're getting here. Are you seeing that around the country?
Yes, absolutely. And I think you hit the nail on the head. It's trying to establish a new norm. And the fact is that crime did go down from 2010 to 2019. There's no question about that. But we started seeing an increase in the latter part of 2019, and it steadily increased year over year. There was a slight dip in murders from last year, but as you said, a slight, I think it was like a 1.9% decrease. Well, that's really statistically insignificant. I mean, all murders are important, but to investigate, and we have victims associated with it, but those are not numbers that you should be celebrating, because it is a new norm. And if you go back, and one of the things that they love to cite the FBI Unified Crime Reports, which are called the UCRs. The FBI puts them out every year. They're usually a year to 2 years late because of trying to gather the data. And the highest crime rate we had in history since it's been recorded was in the late 1980s, early 1990s. And that's, if you could remember, that's when the crack cocaine epidemic was all over, and there was turf warfare, gangs fighting for territory, and a lot of abuse associated. That's when I was on the job. I was a state trooper and then a KBI special agent, Kansas Bureau of Investigation special agent, and then assigned to DEA for 5 years. So it was an incredible high crime time. And it's not as high now, according to the UCRs. But the problem is the UCRs are spurious. And I've been making the argument for the last 4 years that the data from the FBI is spurious. It's not correct. And it's not correct because, hold on to your seat, but about 40% of law enforcement agencies across the country do not even provide data to the FBI. So we're missing a huge number of percentages associated with crime. So how can you even determine a violent crime rate if you don't have, when you have 40% of the agencies that have not given you information over the past 4 years? And in 2022 alone, only 31% of the agencies didn't provide data. 2021, 40% did not give data. 2022 is better, but 31%. Florida only gave 8% data. Pennsylvania only gave 9% of the data. New York only gave 24% of the data. Maryland, 38%. California, 49%. Illinois, 52%. I can go on and on. And there's some big cities. NYPD did not give any data to the FBI. LAPD, no data. Phoenix, no data. San Francisco, no data. Miami, no data. New Orleans, no data. Pittsburgh, no data. So you cannot make assumptions that crime has gone down when you have 35 to 40% of the agencies in the last 4 years that have not given any data. And the other issue is generally the Department of Justice also puts out another report, which is called the National Crime Victimization Survey, the NCVS. And generally, the crime, the UCR data in the National Crime Victimization Survey actually complement each other. Does that make sense? So they either go up or down, and they're usually relative to each other. In 2021 to 2022, the NCVS indicated an increase in violent crime of 44%. Well, that's a remarkable increase, and it doesn't jive with the data that the FBI puts out at all. So if you take 20% of the crimes that are not going reported anymore, that theoretically would also increase the crime per capita. In many cases, it would increase it significantly.
Now you mentioned a number of large cities in the United States not even reporting data to the FBI. Why would they do that?
Well, it's not because they didn't want to, but the FBI changed the data collection. They changed the software, and they didn't roll it out effective at all in 2019. And some agencies couldn't afford to have the software necessary to do it. They didn't have the manpower to do it, and the old system was working fine for people. They said, "Why are we even putting in?"
So it wasn't nefarious, like they're trying to hide the numbers. They just couldn't get them in due to software issues.
Well, that's one of the main reasons. But I have always made the argument that having a high crime rate is not something that a mayor can celebrate. So there are times when agencies may be slow to report or report things differently because they don't like the outcomes.
Right.
And that's very possible.
Dr. Curry Myers, where can we find more of your work? Because this is fascinating. I could probably have a 3-4 hour full show talking crime and numbers with you. But where can people follow you?
I'm on Substack, drcurrymyers.substack.com, or you can Google me. I'm on X at Dr. Curry Myers. If you just Google Dr. Curry Myers, there'll be a whole bunch of stuff that will come up, and I'm happy to come on anytime and talk about anything. I just put out a Substack op-ed today talking about why it's important to enforce the law when it comes to protesters taking over churches like we've seen recently over this Easter. And a lot of these, like Hamas took over St. Patrick's Church in New York City, and probably no prosecutions will occur. And there's plenty of city violations that could have been used to stop that kind of behavior. If we don't have focused deterrence, folks, we're in a lot of trouble.
He's an applied criminologist, an author, consultant, and he's the retired sheriff of one of the largest sheriff offices in the Midwest in Johnson County, Kansas. Dr. Myers, we'll talk again soon. Thank you.
Thank you. Stay safe.
The Hammer and Nigel Show.
Hey guys, it's Rob from my friends at Universal Windows Direct, and man, they just have an incredible deal going on right now. You can't beat it. Call Universal Windows Direct today at 317-659-7574, and for every two windows you buy, get the next two free. Buy two, get two. Buy four, get four. Buy 20, get 20. There's no limit. Plus, they'll upgrade your new windows to triple pane glass for free. That means extra protection from the elements, a consistent temperature in your home, increased energy efficiency, and reduced heating and cooling costs. plus a quieter and more comfortable home. And in addition to these incredible windows, they're giving you such a great price. Universal Windows Direct right now when you call 317-659-7574, 317-659-7574, to schedule your free in-home estimate today. Buy two, you get two free. Plus, yes, there's more. If you mention my name, Rob Kendall, you get $250 off your project. Universal Windows Direct, tell them Rob sent you.
Hammer and Nigel here for the Low T Center. And listen, the Low T Center, they do so much more than just check out testosterone issues. They really are your one-stop shop for all things men's health. If you have ever thought, do I have sleep apnea? You can get it tested at the Low T Center. They do a little blood work. They can work on your weight loss. They can also screen you for some cancers. So don't be a stranger. Set that appointment up right now. Find a Low T Center near you or just go online, lowtcenter.com. That's lowtcenter.com. Guys, if you've been feeling tired or groggy, noticing a little weight gain, listen, it happens when you get older. Testosterone levels go down. Let the experts at the Low T Center help you out. They really are experts at all things men's health. Set up that appointment right now. LowTCenter.com. Tell them Hammer and Nigel sent you.
Jefferson Shreve stepped up to fight when no one else would. He put it all on the line. And the liberals smeared him for it with ads like this.
Donald Trump and Jefferson Shreve. He's an original supporter of Donald Trump.
They attacked Shreve for being a conservative.
Jefferson Shreve, an A rating from the NRA.
Attacked him for being a loyal Republican.
Look who was there, Jefferson Shreve. He was proud to be on the Trump campaign and proud of his own A rating from the NRA.
All because Shreve would get tough, back the blue, and stop the crime. But we don't have to accept their lawlessness at our border, in our suburbs, in our state. Because Jefferson Shreve is running for Congress, and he's a fighter for law, order, and a secure border. Jefferson Shreve for Congress.
I'm Jefferson Shreve, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Shreve for Congress.
Having health insurance is important. So, if you or anyone in your family has Medicaid or CHIP, listen up. Check your mail for a renewal form from your state. Complete the form and mail it back right away so you don't lose your coverage. If you do lose Medicaid or CHIP, visit healthcare.gov to see if you're eligible to enroll in a low-cost, quality health plan. Keep your family covered. Paid for by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
Indy's leader in patio installation is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule a free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. That's IndyDecorativeConcrete.com.
Woodard Emhart, Henry Reeves & Wagner. Over 140 years specializing exclusively in patent, trademark, trade secret, and copyright law and litigation. On the web at USPatent.com.
This week at Sullivan Hardware and Garden, get 30% off all patio furniture, wicker, Berlin Gardens, poly, cast aluminum, teak, and more.
All right, Matt Baer, what's the latest?
Crashes on 70 on the west side. First one is a crash on the exit ramp from eastbound 72. Sam Jones, the ramp is open, but it is partially blocked. Looking at eastbound 72 downtown, crash before west, blocking the left lane, stopping traffic back to Tibbs Avenue. Southbound 65, stop and go 29th to Meridian Penn. Pike Township, westbound 865, stop traffic from Cooper Road to I-65. And heading towards Hancock County, eastbound 70, stop and go traffic from Post Road out to Cumberland Road. Traffic sponsored by Sullivan Hardware and Garden. This week at Sullivan Hardware and Garden, see their large selection of grills, Weber, Traeger, and the Napoleon, along with the Big Green Egg. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
65 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center at 93 WIBC.
Well, it's almost time for April Fool's.
You stop this foolishness right now.
Hey, Scoob, I think we fooled him.
Wait a minute, you can't fool me that easily.
We don't get fooled again.
Fooling yourself if you don't believe it.
Everybody plays the fool.
Fool around.
He fooled around and went to a movie.
No more fooling around.
April Fool's Day, do anything for you, Jerry?
I mean, after this administration, it's been the longest joke ever. So, no, they've kind of ruined April Fool's for me.
I've never been a big April Fool's Day guy. And now that might surprise some people, but it's just always a day where you go on social media, you can't believe anything that you see, which honestly is most days anyway, but you can't believe anything that you see. Everybody's trying to be wacky. There's always some weirdo that takes it too far. And because of stuff like that, like the radio station's not allowed to do any pranks or anything like that. Like some moron will say something highly inappropriate, not even us, and ruin it for everybody else.
Oh, that makes sense. That's my fears. Like I want to do something funny, but you have to take into consideration how it's going to be received. Right. So anything I want to do is just not going to be that good.
New survey, 54% of people say they've played an April Fool's Day prank on somebody, and 65% say they've had a prank played on them. So, Allison, I defer to you on this one. Are you an April Fool's Day jokester? Have you been on the receiving end of anything?
I remember as a kid, I would love to do them on, like, my parents or my, family, and of course they'd played along. But as a whole anymore, not so much.
Anything ever happened to you, Jerry?
Nothing I probably laughed at. I take things kind of personally. So I don't like when the joke's on me.
Right.
I don't like when the joke's on me. I like to be the giver of the jokes.
Is it considered an April Fool's Day joke to, like, set a bag of poo on fire on somebody's porch, or is that just being a jerk?
Or same thing. Like, I think I saw saran wrap over the inside of the toilet lid.
Well, if you've no that would anything not be about that these funny. Bathrooms around here, that's probably the safest thing to do.
But that would not be that funny.
What happened to the bathroom over here? I was gone for like 2 days. I come back and like the bathrooms are out of commission. There's a fan in the hallway. Like what happened here?
Well, like a true suspect, it seems like you fled the scene after you did whatever you did.
Okay.
Literally within like 8 hours of you leaving, all of a sudden the whole floor had sewage everywhere and we had to shut down both the men's and women's. So for 2 days we
did you drop
all
a hammer
here
in
on
there?
This floor.
No, I'm telling you, this is what's going to happen because we have to share a floor with those cretins at the fan. Like, I don't know what kind of diet JMV's on, but whatever it is, it looks like it's a pure hearty meat potato-based diet.
You know, those sports guys take a lot of protein.
Yes. So, if it's bad enough because that unisex bathroom that is across from us, it's legendary for being just something that even in your most hardcore military days, Jerry, I think you'd walk in and go, now I'm shook. Well, now I'm broken.
I did start calling it the latrine. This is the latrine. Everything else is the restroom.
I mean, it is awful. But then the men's and women's restrooms are out of commission. And it's been like that for, I guess, a couple days, right?
Yeah, since Thursday.
It's unbelievable. If you're looking for a reason to drink, today would have been the 92nd birthday of actor Gordon Jump.
Am I wrong for not knowing who that is?
What if I said he was the big guy on WKRP?
As God is my witness, I thought turkeys could fly.
That do anything for you?
No.
Okay. Then you need to sit this conversation out. Why don't you go in the latrine and spin around for a little bit?
Go think about what you just said.
Because I've always been a fan of his work. He's never going to go down as one of the great TV stars in the history of this country, but his role as the boss on WKRP was fantastic. I believe he also did commercials as the Maytag repairman.
Oh, I know who he is. I just looked at his picture. Yeah.
One of those dudes, you're like, I don't know the name, but then you see his picture, bada bing, bada boom. Yep. I know who that is. If you remember, he was the molester on that very special episode of Different Strokes where Dudley and Arnold were in danger of getting molested at the bike shop.
This is a hell of an intro, Jason. This is...
He was the guy at the bike shop. So here's my question to both of you. Let's say you're actors, right? And your agent calls you. Hey, Jerry. Hey, Allison. Listen, everybody loves you on WKRP. They remember you as the Maytag repairman. This show's hot. Everybody loves Different Strokes right now. They want you to be on an episode. But you've got to molest Arnold and Dudley in the bike shop. You got to be the creeper that does that. Are you taking the role?
Zero chance.
Zero it's chance. A popular show. I'm sure they paid well.
Zero chance.
Allison?
I'd think about it.
Okay, well, follow up to that. You've seen all these commercials like, hey, do you suffer from this sexually transmitted disease? Hey, do you... if you're an actor and you get pushed that national commercial, are you taking it?
The poster.
Yeah, you're going to be the poster child of STD curing.
I need to find out what the contract is like. Like, is it a one lump sum or do I get paid in perpetuity? Because if it's a habitual check, then I think I'm in.
Yeah.
Because that means, like, you know, it's not just going to kill your career. You're going to keep getting paid for it.
But then you become the gonorrhea guy.
Yeah, but how much does the gonorrhea guy get paid?
I don't care.
Like, as long as I don't have gonorrhea,
well, you know what? It may
and
be different,
I have gonorrhea money, that's fine with
it
me.
It might be different because you're married. If you're single, do you take it?
Yes, because I can say it's a role. Like, nobody thought Tom Hanks really had AIDS because he played that role in Philadelphia, right?
That's true.
I could totally be the gonorrhea guy, taking that money, putting my feet up on the all-inclusive beaches of Cancun, you know, having, you know, honeys left, honeys to my right.
And explaining to them all that.
Just an acting gig.
Just a commercial, baby.
Right.
Zac Efron played Ted Bundy recently.
Right. And
he's
that dude
fine.
Gets more tail than a toilet
and
seat.
He had all you ladies in love with Ted Bundy.
Toilet seat, Zac Efron. See how we brought it all together right there? Do not go anywhere. Top stories. And we'll have a little conversation about the Indiana gubernatorial race. That's coming up next.
The laundry room. For as long as I can remember, this was the only place to get a good Wi-Fi connection. Until we got Xfinity. Now we have Wi-Fi all over the house. So you're probably wondering why I'm still hanging out in here, when I could be happily streaming in the attic, basement, or literally any other room. Well, the truth is, it's warm in here. And I like the smell of dryer sheets.
Get out of here, weirdo.
Hey, close the door. You're letting cool air in.
That's wall-to-wall Wi-Fi with Xfinity. Now through April 21st, get started with 300 megabit internet for $35 a month for 12 months with a one-year contract and get free Wi-Fi equipment included for a year. Plus, ask how you can save 40% over T-Mobile in your first year. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY or visit a store today. Requires prepaid plan and auto-pay with stored bank account. Restrictions apply. Taxes and fees extra. Actual speeds vary. Compares Xfinity Connect More Internet against T-Mobile Home Internet at $60 per month. Regular pricing applies after promo period.
There is no reason to live with achy joints. There's no reason to live with pain. And there's no reason not to seek out help. That help is at QC Kinetics in Eagle Creek, in Greenwood, and in Carmel. Under the leadership of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Scheinkup, QC Kinetics can help you get rid of joint pain with no surgery, no drugs, and no steroids. That's right. These are no longer your best options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative treatments that deliver lasting results. We're talking natural biologics, using your body's own power to repair and restore damaged joint tissue. Talk to QC Kinetics today. Get a free consultation. They even have Saturday hours, so you have no downtime at work. Call QC Kinetics today and tell them Tony Katz sent you. QC Kinetics is in Eagle Creek, in Greenwood, and in Carmel. Call today. 317-559-PAIN. That's 317-559-PAIN. QC Kinetics. 317-559-PAIN.
Hey, it's Big Joe for your trusted local independent American Standard heating and air conditioning dealer, Absolute Comfort. Chris Wedekin is the owner, and he tells us why many homeowners are giving up their air conditioners for a high-efficiency heat pump.
By removing your air conditioner and replacing it with a heat pump, you are not only saving by getting a higher-efficiency air conditioner, the heat pump works in reverse and saves you money in the wintertime as well.
See if a heat pump is the right move for you by going to AbsoluteComfort.org. Absolute Comfort is your trusted local independent American Standard heating and air conditioning dealer.
Are you over 30 and putting off life insurance? It's time to get a quick quote from Ethos, a better, easier way to get term life insurance, all online with no medical exam. Answer a few health questions and you could be approved for up to $2 million. Isn't it worth 10 minutes to help protect your family's financial security? Ethos, up to $2 million in coverage with no medical exam. Some policies as low as $1 a day. Answer a few health questions and get your free quote at checkethos.com. That's checkethos.com.
When life happens, Michelas happens to help you through it. That includes water, storms, fire, and the whole insurance mess. Working hand in hand with the claims adjuster, Michelas is your advocate, your voice, your local trusted advisor for cleaning up, building back, and moving forward when disaster strikes. Now that is an insurance policy. Make it Michelas. Call 844-FIX-INDY.
Coming up in 2 minutes, what to know about the chances for storms tonight and tomorrow.
what happened during a Delphi court hearing a few weeks ago and why one candidate for Indiana governor says he's only focused on his campaign, not his competitors. All that and more coming up after Fox News Radio from the Technology Recycler Studios. You're listening to 93 WIBC, WIBC HD1 Indianapolis. It's 5 o'clock.
They're making headway in Baltimore. I'm Lisa Brady, Fox News. There's now a temporary channel on one side of the collapsed Key Bridge after cranes moved tons of debris, but still no estimate on when the Port of Baltimore could reopen. And the bodies of four construction workers have not been recovered.
The brave members of our underwater rescue teams remain on standby. They will resume their recovery efforts once the unified command has been notified that it's safe for them to resume diving operations.
State Police Colonel Roland Butler, two other workers were found in a submerged truck last week. A key abortion ruling in Florida just in. The state Supreme Court says Florida's ban on most abortions after 15 weeks of pregnancy stands, which means a more restrictive six-week ban will kick in. That was passed last year when the 15-week law was already being challenged. Plaintiffs, including Planned Parenthood and the American Civil Liberties Union, arguing unsuccessfully that a unique privacy clause in the Florida Constitution protects the right to abortion. Lawyers for the state said when voters adopted that clause in 1980, few people realized it would cover abortion. But Florida voters will now have a say on abortion. The state Supreme Court also ruling that constitutional amendments on abortion rights and recreational marijuana can be added to this November's ballot. The man accused of gunning down a New York City police officer during a traffic stop is indicted. Guy Rivera charged with first-degree murder and attempted murder of a sergeant at the scene.
Going after law enforcement in the city of New York sends a message. We want to send a message back. You can't do that. We will indict you for it.
Queens DA Melinda Katz says a second suspect who was driving the car is also indicted on gun charges, including a former gun possession count. Lindy Jones had been out on bail for that. Now he's held without bail. Rivera remains hospitalized. The officer killed Jonathan Diller has been posthumously promoted to detective. America is listening to Fox News.
93 WIBC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
Why you should keep an eye of what's happening on your radar. Cloudy, 66 degrees in downtown Indianapolis. All clear on that radar in Indianapolis. Those storms to the northeast, they're on the way north of Indy. Low of 58 expected tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 5:02. Severe weather's expected to impact the state tonight, possibly tomorrow too, says Greg Mello with the National Weather Service.
Not only for Monday, but also into Tuesday as well. And, you know, the threat for severe weather will be impactful to anyone traveling, but also the threat for flooding too, so. You have to make sure that you're weather aware before you head out.
Mello says that severe weather will likely be gone by tomorrow night. Snow, a possibility later in the week. The transcript of the March 18th Delphi murders case hearings now publicly available. Donnie Burgess reports.
It was a long day of testimony last month, but one of the more notable appearances was that of Todd Click, former Rushville cop and current patrol agent with Indiana State Police. Click testified that he, along with two other investigators, believed they had strong cases against other men who could have been responsible for killing Abigail Williams and Liberty German. Click testified that he voiced concerns to Carroll County Prosecutor Nick McClelland, but the state moved on with its case against Richard Allen. The defense argues Todd Click is just one of several people involved in the case that provide a perspective that could prove Allen's innocence. The full transcript is at WIBC.com. Donnie Burgess, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
Republican candidate for Indiana Governor Curtis Hill says his campaign isn't focused on other candidates.
We're not out there slinging unnecessary mud. We're talking about the issues that people are interested in. We're talking about the assault on absolute truth. We're talking about the manipulation of justice, the weaponization of race, the sexualization of children.
Indiana's former attorney general is one of several candidates who spoke with WIBC's Tony Katch. You can listen to all the candidates' interviews at WIBC.com. Congresswoman Victoria Spartz says the southern border needs to be addressed by Republicans either now or after the coming election.
The terrorists right now that can come through our border, and also the huge problem for welfare system. You know, we cannot have illegal immigration to welfare. Our system is already bankrupt.
She tells All Indiana Politics the reason she's seeking another term is because Republicans have failed to deliver on key issues like the border. She wants to help straighten things out. And former Colts cornerback Vontae Davis passed away today. Police say he was found unresponsive in his home. No foul play suspected. He was 35 years old. You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 5:04.
Mortgage rates have lowered going into the spring selling season. Now is the time to act to maximize your equity. Mark Dietl has the plan and experience to sell your home fast and for maximum value this spring. Maybe you want maximum equity from your home, but not sure how. Mark Dietl guarantees your home sold at a mutually agreed upon price and deadline, or he will buy it. Listen to what Katie and Chris in Perry Township had to say about working with Mark Dietl. Sadly, our marriage was ending and we were both ready to sell the home and move forward ASAP. Mark Dietl is the man for this job. Our home sold for more than we anticipated in 24 hours with 17 showings and multiple offers thanks to the Mark Dietl team. Call the agent I trust and recommend and the agent who guarantees your home sold or he'll buy it. Call Mark Dietl, 317-755-4232 for all the details or go online to markdietl.com. That's Mark, D-I-E-T-E-L.com.
The traffic on the fives at 5:05. Here's Matt Baer.
All right, Harrison, on the west side, you might be stuck on 70. Good news, the crash did clear eastbound 70 before west. Traffic still stopped back to Holt Road. Front of the line is on the move. Southbound 65, stop and go traffic 29th at 2 Meridian Pen. Eastbound 465, northeast side slows Keystone Avenue over to Allisonville Road. Northwest side, technically Boone County, westbound 865, stop traffic around Cooper Road to I-65. And eastbound 70 out of the east side towards Hancock County. Still a little bit slow from Post Road out to Mithoffer. Traffic sponsored by Mr. Quick Home Services, now hiring. Mr. Quick is offering a paid apprenticeship to become a heating and AC technician, $17 an hour, while learning a trade with six-figure earning potential. Class starts April 15th. Register at jobs.com. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
For today, scattered strong storms possible in the evening hours, widespread showers and storms in the overnight, high temperatures in the mid-60s. Tonight, low temperatures in the mid-50s. I'm Wish TV StormTrack 8 meteorologist Ryan Morse for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on The Level on the Go and on WIBC.com.
Hammer and Nigel.
Can you believe these characters are weirdos?
So let's rock it!
Happy Monday, Monday fun day. It's the Hammer and Nigel show. I'm Jason Hammer. Big Nige is out all week. Indy Spanglish. Jerry Lopez is in. Jerry, the calendar says April now. So we are getting closer and closer to that all-important May primary here in the state of Indiana. We've had a few gubernatorial debates. We've had a few events. Let's kind of handicap the field here. Braun, Chambers, Doden, Crouch, Rittenour, Hill. Give me your thoughts on what you've seen so far.
So Braun's definitely the front runner. I think that comes as no surprise. That doesn't mean he's the most liked, I'm starting to see. But I think the name recognition, the fact that he's been around the city for so long or the state for so long.
He's not liked because he's number one. Those arrows come at you when you're number one.
Right. But I think a lot of this, you know, it's a shame that more people don't do their own research on each candidate as opposed to just following the field.
Agreed.
Right? I personally like Curtis Hill. I like what he stands for. I like a lot of his thoughts on DEI and different things like that. But he's pulling at like 2%.
Why isn't he polling better? Because he was a very popular attorney general. And then, whether you like it or not, he dealt with some Me Too stuff.
Yep.
And trying to come back, I mean, his policies are still the same as they were before. He hasn't changed who he is politically. Why isn't he polling better?
Well, I mean, it would help if you got bankrolled, right? If you got bankrolled, like I think a guy from Illinois, a big donor, gave Braun a bunch of money. Obviously, Doden is self-funded, has a lot of money. Chambers is a business guy, a lot of money.
Hulk, a lot of rich guys.
A lot of rich guys. Yeah, Crouch, I don't want to say I'm lukewarm on her. I also don't want to disparage her because I think she's done a fine job. My issue for her is it's hard to disassociate her with the Holcomb campaign because she was a lieutenant governor. So when they talk about things like shutting down schools or mask mandates, that's a cross she has to bear, and it seems like she's kind of passed the buck on that.
You're right, and I know Rob Kendall called her Silent Suzanne, and the reason he said that is You had every opportunity to speak out against what your boss was doing. Like, I don't think she just woke up one day and said, you know what? I think I'm going to run for the governor. Like, she probably had this game plan for a while. So why not step out and say, I think it's wrong that this state is shutting people down. I think it's wrong that kids can't go to school. And if I'm the governor, you know, if I move one seat forward, it'd be a whole new ballgame. But she didn't do that.
No, and that's the problem that she's having, is now people are starting to call her out on that. Right? Even if she has no say, even if Governor Holcomb is the guy that makes he's the ultimate decision maker, at least she could have stood up and said something publicly like, hey, look, it's not my decision, but I don't like this, I don't like that.
And when I look at Jamie Rittenour, I respect the game, I respect the hustle, I respect the politics, but it takes money, it does, and I just don't think she's going to get the backing to make any noise here. And like Curtis Hill, she's not polling high enough to kind of be considered a serious candidate at this point.
Yeah, and I respect the hell out of her because she is the epitome of if you don't like something, run.
100%.
And she did, and that's right. To be respected.
And I wish more people did that.
100%.
But the problem is we always say, I want more people to say, I'm going to run, but the same people fund the candidates that you want to beat or move past, and it's hard because money talks and everything else walks.
Yep.
So that's kind of where we're at right now with the gubernatorial race. Let me know your thoughts on Twitter at Hammer and Nigel. We're on Facebook, Instagram, the YouTube chat's rocking and rolling. The in-studio camera is there at WIBC on YouTube, and you'll be able to find the show. Miss Allison, I need some mood music.
Oh, and everybody's heard about the bird.
Oh, here we go. Just when you thought it was safe to go outside, another election year virus might be right around the corner. The Good Time Party Boys from the CDC, the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, have announced that a person in Texas has tested positive for bird flu, H5N1 bird flu. So we all thought that they would try to bring COVID back this year, but the CDC, it's like if this were professional wrestling, the music would hit. Oh my God, that's bird flu's music.
Marching down the aisle.
The bird flu's walking down the aisle. Business is about to pick up. From the CDC, quote, this person had exposure to dairy cattle in Texas, presumed to be infected with a H5N1 virus, which is bird flu. The patient reported eye redness as their only symptom and is recovering. The patient was told to isolate and being treated with an antiviral drug for the flu. So if eye soreness and irritation is the only thing here, do we really know it's bird flu?
Well, I wonder. So it says it had exposure to dairy cattle. Did he put his eye on a camel's kettle's butt, or like, well, how did that even happen?
Right. And how does it get in your eye? Like, that's a very important question. Now, I'm sure it went from hand to the eye, sure. But maybe it went directly from udder to eye. I don't know. I don't know how it works.
In the
Jerry.
Words of CDC and Little John, though, you can imagine more shot, 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 shot.
This is the second case of a human testing positive for H5N1 after a previous case was observed in Colorado last year.
Wasn't this a thing during the Biden-Obama administration? Bird flu?
I lose track of my seasonal viruses. There was swine flu, there was SARS, and honestly, COVID was supposed to be on that track, but Donald Trump was the president and had a good economy. So we've got to make a big, huge deal out of it. Do you do LinkedIn at all on your social media?
I have it, but not really, no.
I use it once in a while. It's a networking thing. I'm trying to get guests to come on the show, and I talk to people. But it's so uptight and stuffy.
Yeah, it's corporate social media.
Right. It totally is. Now, they're experimenting with a TikTok-like video feed in their app. So LinkedIn, the stuffy, uptight, we're business people. Don't you dare post a picture of your cat people. They're going to start having wacky videos on there. Are we all right with this?
I don't think they're going to be wacky videos. I think they're going to be like the CEO doing some sit-down 30-second video. I hope that employees start making videos, and you might get me back, LinkedIn. You might get me back.
Yeah.
I think they're going to be stuffy videos.
Honestly, I enjoy LinkedIn, and I know I'm going to get, like, raked over the coals on this, more so than Truth Social. Because Truth Social, it just never really took off. Now, the buyers, the stock took off, but I just, for the Hammer and Nigel show, because we had an account and we posted a few things on there, never really saw a lot of action on it.
I'm going to let you in on a secret. Don't have Truth Social. Never did.
Yeah.
Never did.
I mean, honestly, I don't like the ones that I have. Like, the Hammer and Nigel show account on Facebook is restricted because Zuckerberg is a Zucker nerd.
Right.
I love Twitter, X, whatever you want to call it. It's the wild, wild west, yep. And I'm here for it. I do LinkedIn for professional stuff. The YouTube stream is fun. I don't know why anybody would want to watch guys talking to a microphone, but you've got the opportunity to do so if you want. But, yeah, if I'm ranking them, man, I think Facebook might be at the bottom. But the thing is, we used to get a lot of action out of Facebook. We had shares and posts and all that kind of stuff. And then Zuckerberg suspended us. I appealed it. I won the appeal, but they never brought our reach back.
Wow.
So if anybody is an expert on how to fix that kind of crap, let me know. Because I'm all about crapping all over Zuckerberg and getting our reach back to where it was. Matt Bear.
Yeah, Hammer. Crash clear coming into downtown from the west side. It's eastbound 70 now. Stop and go in parts from Holt Road to the south split. But man, is it thinned out and people are at least moving now. Southbound 65 stop and go traffic from 29th to Meridian Penn. Crash on the exit ramp from eastbound 72. Sam Jones report of a vehicle that rolled. Right now the ramp is open. It is partially blocked. And on the northwest side, westbound 865 is jammed from Cooper Road over to I-65. Traffic sponsored by Train Heating and Cooling Systems. Get a great deal this spring on a new Train Heating and Cooling System. Train systems are engineered to keep up with you. Visit traininfo.com to find your local independent train dealer and learn more. It's hard to stop a train. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
Right now, we are looking at 65 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center, and we'll play a fun round of Are You Okay With This? Next.
The Voice of Health Minute with Dr. Robert Prather of Holistic Integration.
So let's talk about, because we know, what is the better model of healthcare?
The FDA has two different systems of getting things approved. One is what's called structure function. The other one is called disease care. What we're looking at is really primary care should be structure function based.
Mm-hmm.
And that should be 80% of all the care that's provided. The specialists should be 20% of the healthcare model. Your oncologists, gastroenterologists, cardiologists, and the disease care model is a pharmaceutical and surgical based model. We have the best disease care model in the world, but we have the worst outcomes because we don't have the structure function.
Mm-hmm.
You have to change the game and add the structure function in. Otherwise, we're just wasting our time.
The Voice of Health with Dr. Robert Prather, Sundays at 8 p.m. or anytime at thevoiceofhealthradio.com.
Fellas, there's a lot of people talking about testosterone, but do your homework and go to a provider that you can trust. We recommend Low T Center to get your levels checked. At Low T Center, they make it quick and easy. You walk in and take a simple blood test, and you'll get your results back in about 25 minutes.
If you've been feeling tired, grumpy, have noticed weight gain and loss of muscle mass, you may have low T levels. Go to lowtcenter.com and book your appointment online. That's lowtcenter.com. Low T Center, reinventing men's healthcare.
BoerRemodeling.com, serving Central Indiana for 23 years. These are your kitchen and bathroom remodeling specialists. When you're ready to make the change, they're ready for you. It's a new year, so it's time to get it done. That kitchen, that heart of the home, the bathroom, a place where you can actually relax and build instant equity in your home. 317-852-5546 or online at Boer, B-O-O-H-E-R, BoerRemodeling.com.
Yeah, we've been telling you about Palavana Cubano, the best place to get a Cuban sandwich in Indy. It's in the Garage Food Hall there in the Bottleworks District. They have the most authentic, mouthwatering Cuban sandwiches, coffee, and pastries you've ever tasted. And don't forget about Jay's Lobster and Fish Market.
I had the hot honey fried lobster roll. It's unbelievable. Jay's, they specialize in lobster rolls, but they also have incredible lobster mac and cheese. Jay's Lobster and Fish Market. Tell them Hammer and Nigel sent you.
Sometimes I struggle to get to sleep. My body stopped for the day, but my mind is still running. So I take ZzzQuil.
ZzzQuil, the world's number one sleep aid brand, has a range of non-habit-forming products to fit you and your family's needs. Invest in a great night's sleep for the best you tomorrow.
I'm awake and ready to take on anything.
Better days start with ZzzQuil Nights. Explore our products at ZzzQuil.com.
Use as directed. Keep out of reach of children.
Dents happen. There's a whole lot of stuff that can mess up the look of your vehicle. Don't paint your car. Go PDR with Kill a Dent Removal. PDR is paintless dent removal that saves your factory finish and is way less invasive than traditional body shop repairs. And it's faster, too, sometimes same day. Google Kill a Dent Removal and check out the reviews and photos. Then schedule your repair. Hail, baseballs, kids, fender benders, shopping carts, flying cows, angry exes, and anything else that leaves dents. Don't paint your car. Go PDR with Kill a Dent Removal.
This week at Sullivan Hardware and Garden, see their large selection of grills. Weber, Traeger, and Napoleon, along with the Big Green Egg.
Okay, let's begin.
Are you really okay with this?
Are you okay?
Everything's gonna be okay.
Are you okay?
Are you okay?
Yeah.
I'm fine.
I'm pretty f***ing far from okay.
Whoa. Are you okay with this?
On the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Oh, yeah!
So, with Big Nige being out, normally he hosts this and I respond. I'm going to be the gracious host this week. I'm going to run a couple things, not only by the Jer Bear here, Jerry Lopez, but Miss Allison as well. I want both of your input on this and tell me if you're all right with these.
It's about time.
Allison, we'll start with you on this one, actually. Some people are not happy with a minor league baseball team called the St. Paul Saints. They are a affiliate of the Minnesota Twins. Every year, they do this wacky minor league baseball type of thing where they have a pig that comes out and it delivers the game balls to the umpire. Well, every year, they have a fun contest and they name the pig. This year, it's Ozempig. That's the name of the pig, Ozempig. And now fat people are all upset. Now, I've said this earlier. I'm the official spokesperson of fat people. I think this is hilarious. I have no problem with this. I'm okay with this, but I want to find out what the brain trust in this room thinks. We'll start with Allison.
Yeah, I'm okay with it. I think truly they were just looking for a pun, and they found an accurate pun. So I think it's okay, everyone.
Jerry?
I think if the shoe fits, you got to wear it. Just don't eat it, right? at least they didn't call it Fatty McFastball or something like that. Right.
Like, and, I mean, if you're that upset that a pig is called the weight loss drug, lose some damn weight.
Go walking.
Right. This was one of the tweets that came in when the team, the St. Paul Saints, posted on Twitter the name of their pig this year. Quote, "It's sad that you haven't said a word about this and you think fat people, how do you think fat people will feel showing up at your games?"
Depends on their seating, maybe out of breath.
I said hungry.
Yeah.
That's how I think the fat people are going to feel. They probably want to go hit the hot dog vendor and the peanuts vendor, and I'm going to be that guy this Friday when I go to Victory Field. Are you okay with this? One of those airboat things in Florida. You know, you take them through the Everglades and you look at the gators and the swamp and everything. It overturned in Everglades National Park in West Miami-Dade, leading to the arrest of its operator. The passengers were worried because gators were indeed nearby, and the operator was getting a little too crazy and flipped the boat. Here's one of the passengers talking about the incident.
All of a sudden, the captain wanted to make a U-turn sort of on the water so we could get a better picture of the crocodile, and the boat just flipped on its side, and we're all in the water, and all screaming because the alligator was right there. This doesn't happen often. We said, let's do this, you know, and took a day off even from work. Maybe I should have stayed at work.
Jerry, that it? Are you okay with that?
Man, that guy does not sound white. He had no business in that water with those gators.
His name was Jose Maldonado.
That's what I'm saying. Me and Jose need to have a conversation because we're not supposed to be out there. That is my one of my worst fears. I would be terrified.
So, okay.
I'm out there and it flips and I'm in the water with gators?
There's something about the person that sits in that seat that always has a fear of getting eaten by something.
I'm Cuban. So we don't like water animals, Hammer.
You take rafts from Cuba to Florida. You're going to tell me you don't want to eat them?
But I'm in the middle, dude. I'm in the middle of the raft. You know, I'm not a pusher or nothing.
Like, Nigel, his fear is... It ranges from either being dragged to the bottom by a shark,
yep.
getting mauled by a bear, or gored by like a bull or something.
I'm just worried about water animals, sharks, gators, stuff like that.
Okay, Allison.
I'm not okay with this. And also a tip, your first instinct should probably not be to scream because I believe you'd be attracting the alligators. You probably want to remain calm. You know, try to get out of the way.
You can't think about that when you're upside down in the swamp of the Everglades, can you?
You know, the first thing I'm going to do is remind the women aboard, equal rights are here, baby. Come on. Give me your ID, honey. Go out there and get the gator.
Right. Like, I don't have to be the fastest swimmer. I have to outswim somebody else.
That's it.
That's all it has to be. It's like when you're getting chased by a bear. You don't have to be, you know, the fastest person. You just can't be the slowest.
That's it.
Are you okay with this? A man with a 45-year-old unopened chocolate Easter egg in his fridge has filed paperwork banning his family from even touching it. Allison, you all right with
that? No, no, no. This guy, why? It's not like an action figure where it would gain money or any reason. Like, why are you saving this 45-year-old chocolate?
Who are you to judge what turns this guy on? Maybe some people like the action figure. Maybe some people get off watching chocolate freeze in their fridge. If he's saying don't touch it and he's willing to go forth and sign the paperwork for it, I'm here for it.
He doesn't deserve it. After a year, it's anyone's game.
Jerry?
And the fact that he had to file paperwork seems a little excessive, but he's doing his family a favor. If the wrong person eats that piece of chocolate, it might be game over.
See, the fact that he filed paperwork tells me somebody wanted to screw with it.
Yeah.
So he did everything right. He didn't take matters into his own hands with a weapon. He didn't, you know, try to have somebody laid out by a Sicilian hitman. No, he went to court. He did it the right way.
How old is this guy?
He's 45.
No, the chocolate's 45.
The chocolate's 45. The guy himself is... I'm looking at his picture here. I guess in his 50s.
I have so many more questions.
There's no temptation. If you had a friend, if Nigel had a 45-year-old chocolate in that fridge over there, you wouldn't have any temptation to mess with it.
Eat it.
So
just a little chunk off the ear.
I'm reminded of the drum set scene in Step Brothers where you're told not to touch something.
Yeah.
And then next thing you know, you're rubbing Big Jim and the twins on it just because you know it would irritate the other person. Maybe they hate this guy so much in their family, they were planning to assassinate the egg.
Maybe that's what it is. We're going to throw that away. You need to throw that away.
Right. It's making everything else in here stink. I can't believe we've got something in our fridge from 1977. You've got to get rid of this thing.
That's so gross.
Are you okay with this? 2/3 of Americans who claim they made New Year's resolutions say they have stuck to them so far this year.
New poll, 2/3 of Americans are liars. I don't even remember what my New Year's resolution was.
I didn't make a New Year's resolution. I made mine back in August, and I wanted to lose 50 pounds.
You did the parlay one. Did you stop parlaying?
Well, yes. No parlay 24.
There you go.
That's true. I did that. But the weight loss one, which everybody does, I started August 11th when I was the size of a baby elephant, 271, and we're down to 240.5.
Hey, congratulations.
There you go.
Now, I'm taking a timeout this week. I had one more to burn because when I go on vacation, I go hard in the paint.
Yeah.
You know, I eat, I drink a lot, I do the things. So Daddy needs about 2 more weeks to work off the vacation, but I'll be back. But bringing it back full circle, Allison, did you make a resolution? Did you keep it? And what do you buy about this report?
I don't fully buy the report. I'm with Jerry. I don't think half of them even remember what they did.
No parlay 24 has been so good to me, by the way.
Well, sure has.
I've always said parlay bets are sucker bets. And if you don't know what a parlay bet is, it's where you make multiple bets all into one. You got to get them all right
to win.
Every
single one has to hit. If you miss one out of your 15, you lose the whole thing.
Right. And everybody,
you know how many times I did that this weekend, Hammer? I hit 6 out of 7 days in a row.
Okay.
And ended up with no dollars.
$0 and 0 cents. Because everybody brags when they hit one, right? Yeah. I hit a 10-team parlay last year. Right. How many have you played and what's your winning percentage?
Well, they get you when you see that $5 makes you $1,000, you're like, oh, here we go.
But there's a reason for it, right?
Yep.
No Parlay 24, man. Bet all those games individually. That's where you go. All right. Coming up next, we're going to speak with Reverend Charles Harrison, a friend of the show. He was a hot take machine on social media this past weekend about these juveniles hanging out downtown. Next thing you know, people are being shot. We're going to get his perspective on it. He's never afraid to bring the heat. So we'll talk to him coming up right after the news with Harrison Silcox.
93 WIPC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
More rain on the way. Cloudy, 67 degrees in downtown Indianapolis. No rain in Indy on the radar at the moment, but storms are headed this way from the northwest, low of 58 tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox for Moss Roofing. Here's what's trending at 5:30. There's a threat for severe weather for most this afternoon and evening.
Large hail, mainly that large hail threat. Across the northern portion of the area, we're expecting more just a large hail threat. Less of a tornado potential, wind gust potential tonight, this evening into tonight.
Greg Mellon with the National Weather Service says there's a possibility for a tornado as well. He expects the worst of any storm south of the I-70 corridor. And he had a candidate for governor, Jamie Reitenauer, wants to take a more local approach when it comes to state taxes.
That's why the approach that I'm taking with taxes to go to the ground level, to talk to the counties, to have a conversation about, you know, sewer and water, the infrastructure we know in many of the counties that's going to be a problem.
Right now, we're one of several candidates to speak with Tony Katz about her campaign. You can find all of his interviews at WIBC.com. Maryland Governor Wes Moore says Unified Command has started cleaning up debris from last week's bridge collapse.
They cut up and lifted a piece of the north section of the Key Bridge. The entire operation took 10 hours, and in that time, they were able to cut and lift a 200-ton span of the bridge.
It's all part of the process of reopening the port. Moore says that was just a small piece of the bridge that was removed. A transcript of the March 18th Delphi case hearings finally available for you to read. Donnie Burgess reports on testimony from one police officer involved in the case.
Suspect Richard Allen's legal team called former Rushville cop and current Indiana State Police agent Todd Click to the stand. Click testified that he was with a three-man team investigating other potential suspects as far back as 2018. Click felt the evidence against Richard Allen was weak when he was originally arrested in 2022 and gave his concerns to prosecutor Nick McClelland. The state has since moved on with its case against Allen. The defense says Todd Click's testimony is just a taste of the available evidence and perspective that could prove Allen's innocence. The trial begins May 13th. Donnie Burgess, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
The average price you're paying for a gallon of gas today, $3.40 in Indiana. That's according to GasBuddy.com. It's 10 cents cheaper than the national average. With traffic at 5:32, here's Matt Baer.
All right, Harrison, looking at southbound 65, stop and go traffic, MLK to Meridian Pan, and a stall coming eastbound 70 at Meridian, Illinois. That has cleared traffic, still stop and go back to Belmont. And south side northbound 37, stop and go after Epler up to 465 because of construction. Traffic sponsored by Sullivan Hardware and Garden. This week at Sullivan Hardware and Garden, get 30% off all patio furniture, wicker, Berlin Gardens, poly, cast aluminum, teak, and more. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Down into the 50s tonight with rain and storms. There's also potential for severe weather with wind and hail, the primary threats, but we're also looking out for some flooding too. Tuesday afternoon, also severe threat with all hazards possible. There's potential for significant severe weather east of Indy. I'm Wish TV StormTrack 8 meteorologist Stephen Deanna for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the level, on the go, and on WIBC.com.
The Hammer and Nigel Show.
It is the Hammer and Nigel Show. I'm Jason Hammer. Nigel on spring break with his family. Jerry Lopez, Indy Spanglish on social media filling in. And right now, let's go to the hotline and bring on the pastor at the Barnes United Methodist Church and the man behind the 10-point coalition, Reverend Charles Harrison. Reverend, I know we're a day late here, but let me be the latest to wish you and your family a happy Easter.
Well, thank you so much, and same to you.
So let's talk about what's happening here in Marion County, specifically the high-profile areas of Indianapolis. For the second time in a number of weeks, we've got a mass shooting in a high-profile area. A couple weeks ago, it was in Broad Ripple. This past weekend, downtown Indianapolis, it appears a large number of juveniles were coming out of the mall late at night, and one thing led to another, and you've got gunfire. I'm curious as to your perspective.
Well, certainly you have to be concerned about, you know, what's happening in the city, and particularly when it comes to juveniles. And this is the second time, you know, we've had a mass shooting with juveniles coming out of the mall, around the mall area. We had a mass shooting in 2019 where six juveniles were shot, and here we are again. And I think we really, you know, have to talk about the elephant in the room. When people began to talk about, you know, why, what's going on, and why do we continue to have this in the city? And we really have to focus on this whole issue of parenting with some parents. It's not all parents, but we really have a problem, you know, when it comes to this parenting issue. We have had problems with juveniles downtown for years, but we're not really dealing with the issue of parenting or the lack of parenting. You know, when these kids are behaving unruly in public, it lets you know that there's something going on at home. And if they're allowed to be unruly at home, they're going to be unruly when they're out in public. And too many of these parents no longer have boundaries and curfews when it comes to their children, and they allow them to do whatever they want to do. And this is the tragic result of it, of what we've seen on Saturday and what we have been seeing in many shootings around the city, even this year.
Now, I know it's kind of hard to legislate parenting because, you know, to each their own. But with that being said, we do go after parents whose child commits a crime out of school or different things like that. Do you think the city should be looking at going after parents whose child is out here committing crimes? You know, more straightforward murders or gun crimes?
I think we're going to have to look at something, you know, and I think the city or the legislators may have to relook at these curfew laws. I'm a parent. I have two teenage children that I'm raising. And, you know, it is not the responsibility of law enforcement or community groups to babysit and raise these kids in public. And when they then, you know, pull out a gun and fire shots with a lot of people around, then you have to look at what's going on at home. And maybe we may need to have a conversation, you know, in this city and as a larger society about what do we do with these, not only these juveniles, but with the parents, because the parents have to be responsible for their children. I'm responsible for my two teenage children, me and my wife. And my son and daughter are not going to be carrying a gun or bringing a gun in our household or misbehaving in public and there not be accountability. And if we have that going on in some homes where there is no accountability and parents are not raising these children properly, then maybe we need to look at the parents.
Reverend, this is why I love having you on the program, because you say the things that I think a lot of people may be afraid to say. And this is a city in Indianapolis where the elected officials spend a lot of money looking at their root causes, right? We always hear about the root causes of crime. Well, we know what a big root cause is: lack of a father at home, lack of parents who give a you-know-what about their kids here. So how do we fix this problem? Like, when do those tough conversations need to happen, and why don't we see the mayor and the prosecutor going to the inner cities, going to downtown, you know, speaking about this kind of thing?
Well, they need to happen now because, listen, this is a ticking time bomb. And the next time we may be talking about multiple juveniles who have been killed because there has been a mass shooting somewhere in this city. I think the mayor, the city county council, some of our state elected officials and community leaders like myself need to be having these tough conversations in this city when it comes to this issue of juvenile violence and boys and girls now who are juveniles carrying unlawful weapons, and they're using them now when they have a conflict because they have no moral compass and no regard for the sanctity of life. So we got to deal with the reality of what's happening in our society today and what we see going on in Indianapolis.
What do you think we can do in the future to stop this stuff? I know we started with parenting, and obviously you said the mayor and the council couldn't come out, but I think that when we talk about these kids that are having these issues, they probably look up to members of the community a little bit more than the mayor, people like yourself, or whether it's NBA players or people like B. Swift on the radio or just other local, we'll say local community celebrities. How do we get them in touch with the kids and just let them know that there's a different way to handle any disagreement?
Well, I think we're trying. I think we are. I think we need to look at some of the things that this city has done in the past that has been successful in addressing this. You know, this is not the first time we've had this problem with these kids downtown. It used to be just fighting. But when we had celebrities, community leaders, law enforcement, the mayor's office, all of us standing hand in hand, working together to address this problem, then we have come up with some pretty good solutions in dealing with it. And I think we have to do that again as we look at, you know, what's happening with these kids today, what's going on, and how do we address it as a larger community so that we minimize the possibility of these kind of mass shootings happening.
We're chatting with Reverend Charles Harrison here on the Hammer and Nigel Show. Reverend, what's your reaction when you hear people just blame the guns, right? Listen, I am a 2A supporter. You know, I am trained. My kids are trained on the right way to use a firearm. But even I will admit, there's a lot of guns out there on the street. But at the same time, they fall into the hands of people who aren't legally allowed to have guns anyway. And in some cases, we're seeing very young kids being involved in shootings here. So what's your reaction when you hear, like, city leaders just blame the guns and nothing else?
And let me cut in real quick. For our listeners and for me, really, how does a 12-year-old even get their hand on a gun?
Well, it's easy out there, and I focus not on the guns. I focus on the issue of why would a 12-year-old or a 13-year-old or a 15-year-old or a 17-year-old or 18-year-old use a gun to settle a conflict? It's not the gun. It is the issue today, in my opinion, that these kids have no moral compass and no regard for the sanctity of human life. Now, how do we address that as a city? These kids today are doing things that we would never do when we were their age. But yet these kids are crossing that line today. So we got to have this larger conversation, because if it's not a gun, it's going to be something else that these kids use to harm another human being. And we have to really address the root cause of this. And again, gentlemen, it starts at home. It's what you teach your children as a parent as to what is right and what is wrong and how to conduct themselves as a human being.
Reverend, one more thing here before we let you go. You told us something a while back, and it really has stayed with me. In regards to giving hope to the city of Indianapolis, look at a city like Boston, right? Boston is a major metropolitan city. Their politics are pretty much aligned the same way that the city of Indianapolis is. But they've got a pretty good handle on the crime and the homicide rates. If you could, because I know you've studied this just a little bit, tell me the difference between what's going on in Boston and what's going on here in Indianapolis.
Well, they're holding people accountable in Boston. They are. They're holding people accountable in Boston who are repeat violent offenders, and the city is working together on the issue of public safety, and they don't allow politics to get in the way of what's best for their city. What was working in Indianapolis in the early 2000s up until about 2012, we stopped doing because we allowed politics to get in the way of public safety. We need to do what Boston is doing, do what we know that works, and continue to do it regardless of who the mayor is or who's sitting on the city county council or who's the president of city county council, because we know certain things work. And if we do it here in Indianapolis and go back to what worked, then we would see less violence in our city and our numbers would be close to what we're seeing in Boston.
And Boston is under 100 homicides annually, correct?
Yes. I think they had 40-something homicides last year of a city of about 667,000 people.
Man, and here in Indianapolis, we're accepting over 200 every year now, and certain officials are doing victory laps because of it. Reverend, we always appreciate you being honest, taking the time, and doing what you do. Thank you so much, and God bless.
God bless both of you. Thank you.
It's the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Get ready for storm season because you know as well as I do, storms in Indiana can be fierce and they can come out of nowhere. So don't wait for a leak to have your roof inspected. Have peace of mind about your roof being able to handle any storm. Moss Roofing, M-O-S-S, mossroofing.com provides free inspections and can spot potential issues before they turn into costly repairs. Whether you're looking for a siding replacement after a strong wind or a roof replacement after a hailstorm, Moss Roofing has options that fit any budget. Just ask Moss Roofing about their payment plans. No matter your situation, Moss Roofing has you covered with a job done right every single time. I love that. That's very funny. Contact Moss Roofing today. 317-747-3665. 317-747-3665. Tell them Tony Katz sent you. Moss Roofing, 747-3665 or online at Moss, M-O-S-S, mossroofing.com.
Business. It's not a 9-to-5 proposition. It's all day and into the night. It's all the things that keep this world turning. And behind every one of these businesses is a partner like Comcast Business helping to keep it all moving. It's why the local flower shop and your favorite pizza joint, the startup in the stadium, hospitals and hotels, banks and restaurants nationwide, all these businesses choose the advanced network, cybersecurity solutions, and round-the-clock trusted partnership from Comcast Business. From Main Street to Wall Street, our people are powering the businesses that power it all. So when you're ready to unlock what's possible for your business, there's no one better to answer the call. Comcast Business, powering possibilities.
Restrictions apply. Call or visit ComcastBusiness.com to learn more.
Kate here from Baths R Us with the three biggest problems people always have with bathroom remodelers and how Baths R Us overcomes them all. First, it takes too long. Everyone's heard the horror stories of jobs that drag on for weeks or months, but at Baths R Us, we're in and out in 2 or 3 days and it looks stunning. Problem number two, the final bill is more than the original estimate. Baths R Us doesn't give estimates. We give ironclad quotes. We remodel over 1,500 bathrooms a year. You can be confident there will be no last-minute surprises. And problem number three, they don't do the job right. Baths R Us only hires master craftsmen who are trained and certified and who use the highest quality materials. That's why we're proud to offer our no-regrets promise, your personal guarantee that you'll love your new bathroom. Call right now and get $1,500 off plus low to no monthly payments. Our number is 317-886-1761. Or online at BathsRUs.com. That's BathsRUs.com.
Attention seniors, you're invited to the grand opening of CenterWell Pendleton Pike. CenterWell offers primary care centered on seniors. So come celebrate on Wednesday, April 10th at 8101 Pendleton Pike, Suite E in Indianapolis from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Enjoy food, music, and more at this free community event. Plus, tour the new doctor's office and meet the care team. For details, call 317-648 5581 or visit meetcenterwellindiana.com.
Join Fiji Auctioneers for the Spring Midwest Construction and Farm Public Auction on Thursday, April 4th in Clayton. Bid live on-site or online at buyfiji.com. License AC312-00002.
Indy's leader in patio installation is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule a free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. That's IndyDecorativeConcrete.com.
What is the most overrated vacation spot? There's a new story out about it. We'll talk about that coming up right now. Matt Baer's got to look at the roads.
All right, Hammer, here it is. Serious crash, place to avoid, northbound Keystone Avenue at East 46th Street. Three cars involved in this one up on the curb. Lots of response there and heading in that direction against northbound Keystone Avenue at East 46th Street. Two right lanes are blocked, leaving only the left lane available for travel. Now we are backed up to Fall Creek Parkway, Bemford Boulevard. Also looking at eastbound at 70, still is a bit slow to downtown because of an earlier crash and a stall, but most of the traffic has cleared out. Southbound 65, stop and go MLK to Meridian Penn. Traffic sponsored by Sullivan Hardware and Garden. This week at Sullivan Hardware and Garden, see their large selection of grills, Weber, Traeger, and Napoleon, along with the Big Green Egg. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
Right now it's 66 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center at 93 WIBC. You may have heard in the news earlier today, sad news, man. This is a bummer. Vontae Davis, he was a Colts player for a while, part of the secondary, Pro Bowler. Had some really good years here in Indy. Found dead in his home today at the age of 35, Jerry. Just 35.
Yeah, 35 is so young. You know, I remember being a kid and thinking 30s were old. And I'm 42, and it's like, man, I'm 7 years older than this guy. What a sad, sad day. Sports aside, it's never good when a 35-year-old just passes away at home. No suspected foul play.
None.
No idea yet, waiting for everything else. But, yeah, that just stinks for anybody.
No foul play and just asleep at his house, never woke up. Yeah. 35-year-old. Now, if you remember, Vontae Davis, he had some interesting moments in the NFL. We were talking off the air about when he found out he got traded.
Yeah, so he got, they have a show called Hard Knocks. And so it's basically, what do they call it? Preseason, right? They take through and they
right,
kind of
training camp.
Yeah, show these players doing things. Kind of like they did with the Colts, except for it was preseason. And he was somewhere and they said, we're trading you to Indianapolis. And he had this look on his face and he goes, can I call my grandma?
Right. And there was a time where I think he was still with Buffalo where he just decided he was done.
Yeah, he retired in the middle of the game at halftime.
Yeah, like drove home with his uniform, yep, like still partially on. He was out.
Yeah,
he was done. So Vontae Davis dead at the age of 35. All right. A new study has ranked the most overrated tourist locations in America. Tell me how you feel about this. The top five: Mount Rushmore, Las Vegas, Plymouth Rock, Times Square, and Lombard Street in San Francisco.
I don't know what Lombard Street is, but I would definitely say Mount Rushmore is probably up there. Cool to see. I don't know that I need to do anything more than drive past it.
Right. Like, once you see it, like, man, that's breathtaking. I'm proud to be an American. Look at those great Americans up there. You look at your watch about 10 minutes later.
How far to the next rest stop?
Is there anything else to do here? You know, is there a restaurant? Is there a shopping? What do we do? Now, I will defend Las Vegas because I don't know what more these people in the survey are looking for, because you've got first-class dining, you know, all of these concerts and entertainment. There's professional sports there. You can go zip lining. You can drink. You can gamble. What are you looking for that you put right, Las Vegas on this list of overrated attractions?
Seems like it checked all the boxes that are necessary.
Right. Like, even if you just want to stay in a hotel away from the gambling, you know, Trump's Hotel, no gambling in there. There's a couple other that are just hotels and resorts, no gambling, no smoking. You can just people watch, enjoy the fountains and the lights, and you don't have to do all the debaucherous stuff that I do.
Yeah, I think Vegas is probably one of the best tourist attractions, and I'll tell you why. Because I won't go to Vegas because I won't come back. And I'm responsible. It's the same reason I don't have a motorcycle, right?
Right.
I know my boundaries and limitations. You're going to tell me the bars never close. There's parties every day. There's live sporting events. I can bet on sports. I can go over here and see Wayne Newton. I can go over here and see. Why would I leave?
Prostitution is technically illegal, but they don't bust you for it in Vegas. It's like jaywalking. Yeah, it's on the books, but nobody's going to arrest you for that. If you really want to be a legal eagle, you can drive outside the city limits to the Bunny Ranch if that type of thing is for you. But all of these things that we just rattled off, how does it make it to number two on the list of overrated tourist attractions in the United States?
Well, I have heard, so for somebody who's, like I said, I've never been to Vegas, a lot of people say you only need like 2-3 days and that's enough.
That's it. That's it. Because if you stay longer than that, Las Vegas becomes lost wages and you don't have the money to do anything and it's not any fun. I know this because I've been there. Don't go anywhere. Top stories next.
Jefferson Shreve stepped up to fight when no one else would. He put it all on the line, and the liberals smeared him for it with ads like this.
Donald Trump and Jefferson Shreve. He's an original supporter of Donald Trump.
They attacked Shreve for being a conservative.
Jefferson Shreve, an A rating from the NRA.
Attacked him for being a loyal Republican.
Look who was there, Jefferson Shreve. He was proud to be on the Trump campaign and proud of his own A rating from the NRA.
All because Shreve would get tough, back the blue, and stop the crime. But we don't have to accept their lawlessness at our border, in our suburbs, in our state. Because Jefferson Shreve is running for Congress, and he's a fighter for law, order, and a secure border. Jefferson Shreve for Congress.
I'm Jefferson Shreve, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Shreve for Congress.
L.D. Smith Plumbing.
A dirty, stinking honest.
When plumbing problems arise, you need them fixed fast and right. The L.D. Smith Plumbing crew knows how to put water in its place. We do it all, from the kitchen sink to delicate repairs in historic homes, and we'll always give you honest advice at a fair price. So if you're worried about the cost of plumbing repairs, call today for a free second opinion on a competitor's estimate.
L.D. Smith Plumbing.
A dirty, stinking honest.
Life insurance. Why are you putting it off? Can't afford it? Too much hassle?